Give y'all some time to get up in here. Make sure you hit the like button. Come on. You know, usually I play some music, but I want to get really with this. I want you guys to get in here. Hit that like button. Hit that share button right now. Hey, baby. Baby, I miss you too. Hit that like button for me. Hit that share button for me. Hit that subscribe button if you're not subscribed. But by all means, you know, when I speak on the lifestyle, YouTube do not be given the notifications on time. So I need for you guys to push it. I need for you to share it, you know? Hey, Ebony. Hey, baby. You know, all the ladies up in here. What's the word? Oh, bro, you know, man, just obtaining and maintaining, man, by the mercies and grace, you know what I mean, of God and the goodness of this game, man. Blessed with the activity of my limbs, you know what I mean, wiser and flyer than I even was on yesterday, you know what I mean. Blessed to sit up there and communicate, you know what I mean, with my loved ones one more game, man, you know. What's good, brother? What's good with you? What's going on? What's happening, Goldie? Okay, I see my brothers in here. Jay in here. You know what I mean? I'm going to give you guys probably about 2 more minutes before I get started. But hit the like button. Like I said, you know what I mean? They're not going to push the notifications out there. The more likes, the more, you know, basically recommendation that the video will receive. And I want others to see this because I'm going to say some things within this video that I want to be heard. So I need the help of you guys. I need for you to make sure that you hit the like button, but make sure that you share the video. It should be no way that it's already 137 people up in here, but it's only 39 likes, man. Come on, man. Break yourself for the likes. Break yourself for the shares. We talking about the game, baby. You know, it's cold out there. It's freezing out here. No, baby, it's beautiful right now in Scottsdale. The day before yesterday, man, it was raining all day. All day. You know what I mean? The day before yesterday, Scottsdale was looking like old Chicago. You know what I mean? Real talk. Yeah, I'm looking at my tie. You know, on the big screen, let me fix it. Let me fix it a little bit. Make sure everything I want, because, you know, I want you to see that dimple. Yeah, you know, if you notice when Sin tie, you know, Sin tie always got that dimple. Trademark. And you only going to see me with these type of ties every now and then. You know what I mean? Because anybody that been watching me for years, you know that Sin really wears silk solid ties, trademark. You know what I mean? I've been wearing solid and silk ties really all my life, you know, because I come out the Way of Holiness mission. But that's another subject. I'm tired of breaking myself. I can't get no rent. If you don't knock it off, you know the women don't get no wrench here. Stop it. So, bro, I got to holler at you when I get my mind right. Bro, I sat up there and called you and you didn't hit me back, loved one. And y'all make sure the pulpit podcast, everybody that's not subscribed, click on bro's shit right now and hit the subscribe button. I need to be doing more videos with my brother. I want Jap to get back where he supposed to be. And that just show you, that's when you know you that nigga. Anytime where, you know what I mean, you lose your big channel and you got to build up from the ground up and you only got, you know, 3,000 or 4,000 subscribers, but the same 300, 400 people come to see you while you live. That's how you know you got great content. That's how I knew that y'all was fucking with me when they was plaguing the channel and I couldn't go live on this channel. And the Game for Ladies channel was the Sinful World channel. And at that time, we only had like 1,200 subscribers, but it was still 300 people live watching. That's when I knew y'all fucked with me. Shit crazy in the chat right now. I'm trying to not turn up. Okay, I got you, loved one. I got you. Right after I sit up there and do this, I'm going to hit your line. But y'all make sure y'all hit the Pulpit podcast, hit the subscribe button, and hit the bell. That's my brother, Jap. You already know how we riding together. Your content rocks in. Thank you, man. And thank you for the donation, Reno. You already coming up in here, man. Y'all already, hey, man. The way y'all been blessing me lately, you know what I mean? I'm going to be able to buy, you know what I mean, both pair of Stacey Adams. Instead of just getting one shoe out the box and putting it on the other shoe on layaway and shit. If y'all keep making donations and shit, I'm going to be able to sit up there and go to restaurants like the real pimps do, and not only basically sit up there and act like I'm about to buy some food, but I can really do it. Instead of going to the mall looking like I'm about to shop and window shopping, y'all going to help me actually do some shopping, man. Thank you, man. I love y'all, man. I fucks with y'all. What's going on? Kyrie P came up in here with the 20. Some of y'all, I know that y'all really out there pimping and you really out there doing something. I ain't going to put y'all business out there, but with some of the donations that some of y'all be giving, I know that you in these streets really doing something. Like I told you, that nigga Droney, hey man, I think that nigga low-key work at White Castles, but I ain't gonna put his business out there. But shouts out to the homie, man. Shouts out to Jack coming in with the 20. Love, bro. Respect. I got you, big homie. Man, thank you, Christian, man. Appreciate the donation, man. Okay, I feel good. Okay, but before I start, one more time, let's get the likes up. Let's get them likes over 100. It's already 189 people watching. Let's sit up there and get them likes up there, man. Let's get it past 100. I want women to see this. I want not only women to see this, but I want pimps to see this, hoes to see this, max to see this, squares to see this, religious people to see this, subconscious people that think that they conscious to see this. You know what I mean? I want everybody named Mama to see this, man. So help me out, because you know YouTube ain't going to help me, but y'all going to help me, man. Family going to help. Just sub. Thank you. Thank you for subbing to my brother, man. Scorpio was that nigga. Was that nigga. Scorpio is that nigga. This the documentary. Yeah. So getting right into it, you know what I mean? The likes is the likes. You know what I mean? It is what it is. But getting right into it, as you know, Pimps Up and Hoes Down was before American Pimp. We know that, you know, it's a Brent Owens movie. At that time, you know, I actually think that Pimps Up Hoes Down was actually, the film was finished in 97, but I think it came out in 98. You know what I mean? And at that time, this is before, you know what I mean, I got involved in holiness and, you know, got saved and everything. When I first seen Pimps Up Hoes Down, I got to tell you the truth. Of course, I got some things that I took down because I wanted to touch down on so many points. But I want you guys to know that before it was American Pimp, it was Pimps Up, Hoes Down. And that documentary had everybody and their mama wanting to be pimps. Everybody. Blackstone, GD, BD, Vice Lord, Four Corner Hustler, Crip, Blood. You know what I mean? Pimps Up, Hoes Down was everywhere. If you was in the streets and you got a chance to see Pimps Up, Hoes Down, yes, you wanted to pimp and mash on a bitch after seeing that. Especially if you didn't know the game like that and you just basically was, you know, learning from the commercialism that was being conveyed to you on the television. You like, God damn, you know, I didn't know niggas was out here really mashing like that. And of course, you know, on my mother's side, preachers, teachers, lawyers, principals, you know what I mean, on my mother's side. You know what I mean? Of course, my mom, you know, those that know my story, you know, my mom, you know, before she gave her life to God and got involved in holiness and became, you know, who she became in God, my mother was a hoe. But, you know, it ain't about me. I've been told you guys that. Y'all know my story. But back in these times, going back to like 97, 98, at this time, I'm like 13, 14 years old. You know what I mean? And of course, on my father's side, you know, which I already dealt with my mother's side, but on my father's side, you got gangbangers, you got killers, You got, you understand me? Because my father was one of the original black disciples. Of course, you know, as you know, when I came up, I grew up kind of having a hatred towards BDs because one of my friends that I grew up with, you know what I mean? He was a BD and it was an inside job. So not only did I hate them for basically riding under the six and being on some other shit, but you know what I mean? I ended up losing my best friend at that time. You know what I mean? Rest in peace. You know what I mean? David Hatcher. You know, as some of y'all know, as Dizza. But I just didn't care for him. But the truth of the matter is, a BD gave me life. You know, before my father got, you know what I mean, started in the game, my father was one of the BDs. You know what I mean? So on my father's side, you got Max, you got gangsters, you got pimps, you got preachers on his side. He got holiness on his side too, the apostolic side. You know what I mean? Mom's side is the Church of God in Christ. But on Pop's side, it's more apostolic assemblies of God on his side. I'll get into all that later. But, you know, so I wasn't knowledgeable, of course, the way I am now. But as a kid, I done seen some things, you know. But when I seen Pimps Up Hoes Down, I was like, man, this is it. Man, this is the shit. Like, you know, gangbanging is cool, but man, shit, I wanna be a pimp. So let me say that, of course, you know, when the film start, of course, you remember when Bishop was going inside of the barbershop. Okay, and when Bishop going to the barbershop, see, because I'm gonna give you the positive, I'm gonna give you the negative, and I'm gonna give you the meaningless shit. And you know what I mean? When Bishop went up in the barbershop, if you remember, it was a young man sitting in the barber's chair. The bishop was like, you know what I mean? It's from pimp stick to pulpit by the archbishop. Bishop Don Magic Wand. You know what I mean? By the archbishop. You know what I mean? And he was like, yeah, you know, I didn't want her, you know, somebody to do the pimp at. You know what I mean? Because, you know, it was a hard job, shit, but, you know, somebody had to do it, you know? And what I like mostly in the barbershop part is when OG, the general, sit up there and told you, the penitentiary come with all of this. The penitentiary come with all of this. The penitentiary come with all of this. So, shouts out to the general, because if you go back to Pimps Up Hoes Down, the general did make that known. The penitentiary come with all of this, you know, because when Bishop Don Magic Wand was speaking, you know what I mean? The young man was, you know, looking all glossy at it, because a lot of y'all, you know what I mean? A lot of people be hating on Bishop and they say little things here and there about Bishop. But truth be told, a lot of them niggas is fans, man. They fans, because whenever they do any documentary about pimping and hoeing, or they talk about this pimping and hoeing, they know they can't talk about it without basically bringing up the city of Chicago, and you can't talk about it without basically talking to Bishop Don Magic Wand. That's what pretty much give the stamp of approval to a lot of these squares, not to the game, you know what I mean, but to squares, to the world, globally, you know what I mean? A film, basically, you know what I mean? It's it now. It's been approved with Bishop Don Magic Wand, basically, is in it to a lot of these squares. Because they see Bishop Don Magic Wand is the top pimp. I'm not going to get into all of that. But one thing that's not up for debate is Bishop Don Magic Wand, you know what I mean, is the most popular pimp. That's right. Rest in peace to Roy Lee. And blessings to Texas. Blessings to Dallas. Blessings to his family. And may the peace of God that passes all human understanding be with Roy Lee's family and friends at this time, man. Blessings to y'all. But, you know, when Bishop Don Magic Wand is in the film, more squares, you know what I mean? They want to see the shit now. Why? Because they know that the bishop is there in there now. So now they want to see it because they see Bishop Don Magic Wand pretty much as the guy. I'm sharing this on Instagram. Is they see him as pretty much like a godfather, or pretty much really kind of like the god of the gang. So, you know, when you got him in the film, you know what I mean? Everybody and their mama want to see the film now because Bishop Don Magic Wand is in the film. So in the beginning, of course, when the film starts, it showed the bishop. They in the barbershop. The young man is looking at him all glossy at it. But like I said, that's what really stuck out the most was when General said the penitentiary come with all of this. And let me tell you young people this. You like certain videos I've done. You like certain videos that Freeze has done. And even when I, when me and Johnny Cash was on One Accord, you love the work that me and Johnny and Shantae, Silky Slim, Freeze, them type of videos. And after listening to the seeds, you know, that was given within that, you know what I mean, you know, films, I mean, the videos that we did, some of you, after you heard Silky, after you heard Shantae, after you heard Johnny Cash, after you heard Freeze, after you heard me, you was inspired, you know what I mean, to go break a bitch, go charge a bitch, to mash on, to go do some pimping, because it was just like when we was little kids and we used to see Michael Jordan score 30 in the game or 50 in the game. Immediately after seeing, you know what I mean, Michael Jordan scored 50 in Madison Square Garden or score 40 points and hit the buzzer beater on the Detroit Pistons. All of us youngsters used to go in the streets and play on basketball crates in alleys and things, trying to basically repeat what we just saw. And you young people that be listening to Sugar Free and watching different videos about the lifestyle, you ain't really no different. But I'm here to tell you that, you know, this game is not for everybody. And when a lot of the young people saw Pimps Up Hoes Down, they wanted to be a pimp. And that's why I respect the general when he said the penitentiary come with all of this, because if you do something contrary to the rules and regulations, you know, of this game, prison will be your home, especially in today's era. If you come into this game and you don't have a mentor lacing you, giving you some uncommon information, you know what I mean, to basically keep you from going inside of incarceration, you know what I mean, you pretty much predestined for failure in today's time, because it's even worse than what it was in the 90s. If you make one mistake now, you know what I mean, that one mistake will basically cost you your whole damn life. So the penitentiary can come with you joining in the lifestyle. So I respect the general when he said that. Hold on. Click on the link. There we go. But you know what I mean? I respect him when he said that, because really, you know, it was a bunch of nonsense that was being spoken on. So, okay, before I get all into it. Now, moving on. You know what I mean? Because it's a whole bunch of shit that I didn't like. But let me just stay on Bishop right now. Bishop said he spoke on how the police would put toothpicks in his door and ride down basically in his car. If you remember, there was a time when Bishop had spoke about, you know what I mean, how it was really hard. A pimp had to be seasoned in the game because, you know what I mean, the police really had it out there for pimps. You know, pimps was hated on. And didn't nobody have love for a pimp but another pimp. So, you know what I mean? Just being real, if you was really basically having it your way in the game and you riding with Rolls Royce, you know, no disrespect to all them other guys, but, you know, to have a Rolls Royce and to drive it up and down the west side of Chicago, that is the greatest definition of big. You already cool if you got a nice Cadillac. You cool if you got the nice little Benz or whatever. But when you driving a Rolls Royce, custom made, dollar signs on there, zodiac signs and things, and you riding up and down the west side, then the color of that Rolls Royce matches your trademark colors, all of y'all can come together and say he was a clown and, you know, and all of this. But let me tell you something. He from the west side. And see, that's why a lot of y'all don't understand his mentality and the way, you know, say his words and the things that he be saying. Because he from the west side of Chicago, man. You know what I mean? He from the west side. Peace had it here all over the place in the 90s. Yeah, but I'm talking about before the 90s. Because see, Bishop come from the 70s when it come to the pimping. And, you know, the pimp is still the most hated individual, period. You know what I mean? So, you know, in those times, you know what I mean, when you would see Bishop and when you see, they call him God, you know what I mean, Notorious Cadillac and individuals like that. A lot of y'all don't know about Jimmy Valentine, you know, Big Red, you know what I mean? Names that you would pretty much have to talk to, you know what I mean? Because a lot of y'all really don't know about the legacy of Jimmy Valentine, but Jimmy Valentine is one of the best pimps that ever lived. You know what I mean? But a lot of y'all wouldn't know that because all your information comes from documentaries, you know? And what you have to understand is them documentaries is kind of similar to the movies. When them people say action, a lot of people basically put on their best Oscar award performance and say their best 1, 2, 3 pimp nursery rhymes, you know what I mean, to sound more pimpish. And they tell stories that didn't happen, or it didn't happen the way that they say it happened, to basically campaign, to build up their campaign. But, you know, you really can't get no confirmation from reputable, respectable representation in the location of the streets simply because they the only ones that know it. God don't know what happened. The devil don't know what happened. Pimps don't know what happened. The hoes don't know what happened. You know what I mean? He the only one that know what happened. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of them guys really was actors, male actresses. They really wasn't, you know, this pimping. But that's why I like when Bishop was talking about them hard times, because a pimp really had to endure some things to be this pimping, man. Pimping was being hated on by gangbangers. Hit the like button if you just came in. Pimping was being hated on by gangbangers. You know what I mean? Pimping was being hated on by the police. Pimping was being hated on by his family. Pimping had a lot of obstacles, man, that he had to sit up there and get over. A lot of hurdles, man. You know what I mean? A lot of you young motherfuckers don't know. That's why we have to have respect, you know what I mean, for the legendary representation in the ancient times, because they laid the foundation for the recent pimps in the recent times, in the current times. So even if an older pimp say 2 + 2 = 5 and you know it's wrong, everything still got to be presentable before it's acceptable. You come with the correct, respectable presentation when you give information to an older pimp. Still come in the spirit of respect. I'm not telling you to make him a god and exalt him and choose him and all of that shit. But what I'm saying is be respectful to your elders and legends, you know what I mean, in the game that paved the way, whether you basically like what they said, you know what I mean, or not. Bishop also spoke on dedication. I did like that. Dedication in the game, you know what I mean? And he had one little broad, you know what I mean, that had got shot while she was on the track. You know what I mean? The bride basically had got shot on the track. You know what I mean? Went to the hospital. You know what I mean? She all band-aided up. I mean, she all sitting over there, you understand me? Cuts and bullet wounds and all of this all over. You know what I'm saying? Bishop come up in there. You know what I mean? And she say, "Daddy, I wish I could get up from here and get your money." "Hey, baby." You know what I mean? "I wish I could get up from here and get your money." And mama looked at Bishop and she said, "What have you done, you know, to my daughter?" You know what I mean? She didn't know that this game had put her daughter's mind in a whirlwind, man. She was in love with the game. See, it's just like when y'all be saying Michael Jordan is the greatest. That's subjective because everybody don't have that opinion. Some believe Wilt Chamberlain, Bill Russell, you know, but one thing can't be, you know what I mean, debated about, is that 72 win, 10 losses, Chicago Bulls is the best team that ever played. So you could debate on who basically, you know, was the greatest pimp, who in your top 10, who your top 10 NFL players, who the top 10 basketball players. You could do all of that. Shouts out to Clips, man. Thanks for the 10, bro. You can do all of that. You know what I mean? And I like what James said. Different eras, different perspectives, different opinions, different visions. Okay? So, you know, we could talk about who basketball, who played the best, who was the best pimp. But one thing can't be denied is the Bulls basically was the best team ever. You could try to bring Golden State up, but the truth is, it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that ring, man. You know what I mean? And they would have been able to be in the debate if they would have got a ring, but by them sitting over there, you know, losing, they ain't nothing to talk about. So the 72-10 Bulls team is still the best team that has ever played, period. The numbers is agreeing with me. So, you know what I mean? Bishop had hoes. Them older pimps in the 70s, they had bitches that would go through any adversity, any difficulty, sit up in a correctional facility, stay in there for a century, and still get out and sell pussy and bring back all the currency, you understand me, to the pimping top of the morning. You know what I mean? They had solid-ass women. They didn't really have to do a lot of the convincing that the younger pimps got to do today. You had women who actually wanted to be out of poverty. You had women who actually wanted to be something. They don't want to be broke like they mama. You got some young women who had the opportunity to look at their great-grandmother, look at their grandmother, look at their mother, and decide for themselves, I don't want to repeat history. I don't want to keep being in poverty. I don't want to keep being in the ghetto. I don't want to be like my mom and dad. I want to get out of here. So whether he was a dope dealer, basketball player, pimp, or whatever, you had mothers who would actually give their 14, 15, 16, 17-year-old daughter to this pimp or drug dealer. Why? Because he said he was going to Hollywood. He said he was going to Hawaii. And whether you know it or not, it's people that's from the city of Chicago, Detroit, Milwaukee, St. Louis, that ain't never been nowhere. So when you in the city of Chicago, you know, don't be surprised if somebody say, yeah, I'm feel good, you know, I'm about to go out of town. Oh, you going out of town? Oh, for real? Where you about to go? I'm about to go to Indiana. You about to go to, ain't you from Chicago? And you about to go to Indiana? That's out of town to you? But you can't look at them like that. Why? Because it's a lot of people in Chicago, Milwaukee, in the Midwest that have never been anywhere. You got people in Vegas, and the most moving that they ever done was going to California. You got people that say they cross-country pimping, and the only thing they ever did was leave California to go to Vegas and Arizona. But they cross-country pimping, though. Not so. So, you know, I'm saying all that to give you, you know what I mean, the picture, man, to really paint this picture for you of the women that these guys had. You had women, man, that was getting shot, women that was getting into fights, women that were getting stabbed. You know what I'm saying? And these women were, you know what I mean, going through all of this and still staying down with the pimping. It was just a different era, man. The women was way different. You had bitches, you know what I'm saying, that looked like motherfucking Kevin Willis in his rookie year and had a face like Sam Cassell, you know what I mean? But the bitch still hold well. The bitch basically still went through the lake of fire and hell to get a pimp's mail for top of the morning, man. You know what I'm saying? It was just a different time. It was a beautiful era to do some pimping. You know what I mean? I know God don't make no mistakes, but I'm like, man, maybe he put my father, you know, in the era that I was supposed to be in, because I was supposed to be in the 70s, man. I was supposed to be in the 80s when pimping was really live. You know what I mean? Yeah. You know, I wasn't really supposed to be here with a lot of you suckers, but I guess, you know, it wasn't enough of us, so God, you know, allowed me to be here, but I really wasn't supposed to be here with y'all. I really wasn't. But you know what I mean? That's just the truth. It was just a different era. Bishop spoke on dedication. You had women that would stand outside 10 and 15 below zero for a pimp's bankroll in Chicago. You know what I mean? No disrespect to them pimps on the West, because you had some real pimps from the West Coast that was doing some real cross-country pimping. You had pimps, you know what I mean, out the South coming through the Midwest. You know what I mean? But it really took something to pimp in the Midwest and on the East Coast, especially during the winter time, because it's easy to go to the Midwest during the winter time and say, hey, baby, why you want to be up in the snow, man? Let's go, man. You know what I mean? Hey, man, let's go, man, and hit that motherfucker. You know what I mean? Dago, man. Let's go to that Frisco, man. You know what I mean? Get this bankroll, man. You know what I mean? Yeah, man. You know what I mean? You all up in Chicago, baby. It's cold as a motherfucker here, baby. Let's get out of here, man, and go get us something. It's easy for a pimp to come from the West Coast. You know what I mean? Them little hot places with the trees and, you know what I mean? The sun is out there and you come to the Midwest. You could come to the East. You know what I mean? Where it's 10 and 15 below zero and campaign and obtain and knock something and come back out to the West. But it's very hard for a West Coast pimp. That's why all of the pimps from the West Coast, that's from the Bay, that's from Southern Cali, I always give them their props whenever I would see them in places like Chicago. Nigga, you in Milwaukee at the Greyhound trying to have you something as cold as it is. Nigga, you in downtown Minneapolis trying to knock you some snow as cold as it is with all of the snow that's around here. Nigga, you gotta be a real one. You know what I'm saying? So I always gave them their respect because it really takes something. You know what I mean? Because, you know, these women, they'll go to the hotel, post online. They don't mind putting pictures on a website and waiting for dates to come to them. They don't mind going to places like California where the sun is outside, trees and all of that. They don't mind doing that. But as far as coming to Chicago during the wintertime, walking through snow, having the snow walk through snow, yeah, it's different. A lot of them guys don't have that type of stories, man. They never really pimped like that. Some didn't have a lot of money, but they ain't never really done them. If some of these guys right now would leave the West Coast and come to Chicago or come to New York, you know what I mean, during the wintertime, them bitches would blow up, man. Them bitches say it's too cold out here. You know what I mean? If that pimp sit up there and send that bitch in that downtown Minneapolis, man, during that wintertime, man, that bitch gonna sit up there, man, and blow up, man. You know what I mean? Like, ooh, my God, he, ooh, shit, are you sure? That's why I said I give props. Hit the like button right now. Everybody hit the like button. Make sure you click on my channel, on channels too, and subscribe to all my channels. But everybody hit the like button right now. Everybody hit the share button. Everybody hit the subscribe button right now. Make sure you like this video and share. Let's get some more people in here to hear this good game. But, you know what I mean? It really took something. That's why I give so much respect to the nigga Freeze. That nigga Freeze done had bitches, you know what I mean, come through. Man, a lot of you niggas is from the city of Chicago, and Freeze is more known in the city of Chicago than a lot of niggas that's born and raised in the city. I'm not telling you what, you know, I heard or whatever. Freeze has had bitches in the cold all up in the Midwest during the wintertime. Yes, he has. That's why when people sit up there and try to like discredit or minimize, it's very laughable because they've never done some of the things that Freeze has done. It's laughable, very laughable, because if they take their wife or they take their bitch or girlfriend, and they come to Chicago or New York during the wintertime, them bitches is going to blow up. Somebody's going to get knocked. Okay? But if you got a bitch, you know, especially the snow, though, you know what I mean? I love a black hoe, you know what I mean? But I especially got some love, you know what I mean, for a white hoe, too. If you sending the snow, you know what I mean? And she walking through the police, she walking through dogs, because niggas know I'm not lying. You know what I mean? Yeah, that Washington and Kilbourne knows me real well. Yeah, you know, didn't have that snow all out there in front of them vice lords and four corner hustlers and shit. Yeah, you know, them niggas that be thinking that they pimps. You know, I ain't gonna say no names. You know what I mean? But they know me very well. You know what I mean? Motherfuckers knew when Sin was in town because that's when you knew that Sin gotta be in town because we see snow. So if you seen anything Peruvian, if you seen anything Puerto Rican, if you seen anything white and she was dressed right, you know what I mean? 9 out of 10, Sin is in town. Because a lot of them niggas, man, a lot of them niggas be sending scarecrows and shit, you know what I mean, to the blade. So yeah, man, I dealt with that. I'm going through everything. I'm giving you the good and the bad. I like that Donna spoke about dedication because the truth of the matter is, in ancient times, the women really did have dedication. Now you bitches today, if a pimp go to jail and he only got to do 2 months, you bitches is blowing up. Majority of you bitches will sit up there, you understand me, and blow up, and a pimp ain't got nothing to do but motherfucking 2 months and you are ready to blow up. Not 2 years, but 2 motherfucking months and you bitches ready to blow up. You so-called bitches that call yourself hoes today in comparison to the women of yesterday, the real hoes, you bitches is laughable. Laughable. Them hoes back in the day used to work 17 hours to get their man's money. They was the true definition of a hoe. I'm going to get to that, but it's just like Scorpio when he was sitting down with them women and that one woman said, a hoe's job ain't never done. It ain't. That's the mindset of a hoe. Hoeing don't stop. Pippin might send me to the grocery store and I come back with the same money that he gave me, you know what I mean, and shop at the grocery store with. And then I come back with some more of it. Why? Because I'm a hoe. That's a hoe's mentality. Bitch at the gym. Now she talking to this guy. She didn't even know that he is the owner of a multi, you know what I mean, a million-dollar company. Now she dating him and shit. Met him at the gym, though. Or met him at the mall. Met him at the grocery store. Shit. Met him at church. You know what I mean? A hoe's job is never done. As a hoe, the bitches of today in comparison to the bitches of yesterday, it is sad. Pimps got 2 months, a month in jail, and you bitches leave. You blowing up already on the pimping. That's sad. That's some sad shit, man. So I like that Bishop spoke on the dedication. You know what I mean? And I like the fact that he always said that, you know, he could open and close on any corner. Because the truth of the matter is a lot of, you know, let me kill that too. Because a lot of pimps, I fuck with the pimping, but a lot of pimps out in Cali, they be lying. They be lying on the Bishop. Bishop, when he came through, and I got videos, Shantae Parker and a few more P's, even Rosebud, when we were cool, he even told me. You know what I mean? When Bishop came through Cali, when he came through Hollywood, he didn't get knocked. Stop lying. Stop acting like Bishop got ran out of Cali. That's not the truth. You know what I mean? As far as them bothering his bitches and shit like that, the main thing was when you go back and listen to my old videos, you will find out that basically a lot of the Hollywood pimps wasn't feeling Bishop because they looked at basically the appearance of the hoes and they seen cigarette burns and all that because it's already well known that Bishop was tearing that ass up. So, you know what I mean? When they would get high, I forgot this one little place that, you know what I mean, the Hollywood pimps basically would, you know, fellowship in. And, you know, Bishop got his, because the West Side is a bunch of country niggas. You know, so Bishop coming there with his country ass. And while everybody doing a little cocaine, you know what I mean, a little sniff. You know what I mean? I mean, I could just picture it, too. Hold on. I could just really see this shit. You know, pimps in there just enjoying themselves, doing cocaine. And everybody just, you know what I mean, just talking amongst each other, you know what I mean? And they just really, you know, fellowshipping. And Bishop sit up there, man, and break out some PCP. You know what I mean? So, you know, back in the day, man, you know what I mean, that wasn't a pimp's drug. You know, pimps, you know, sniff cocaine. Pimps smoke weed. But pimps, P-I-M-P, wasn't messing with the PCP. So when they seen Bishop, you know what I mean, pull out the PCP, they was like, man, what is this nigga on, man? Hey, man, this nigga hoes, man. You know what I mean? Looking like Joe Louis and shit. Them bitches got cigarette burns, and this nigga doing PCP. Man, you show this nigga some pimping. You know what I mean? That's just how niggas was. Because Sherm was really a drug that Crips was doing, not pimps was doing. You know what I mean? When some of, you know, Crips found out, you know what I mean, that it was some steroids, you know what I mean, it was a form of that, you know, in it. That's why a lot of them started participating, you know what I mean, with the PCP. You know, but as far as the pimps, no, man, the pimps was looking at him crazy. But the truth of the matter is he didn't get knocked and he didn't get ran out of Hollywood. I don't know why they keep telling you the lies. They need to just stop hating on that man. When you the most popular pimp, when you got the most influence in the game, you will have niggas, you know, jealous because they feel like they should have that influence. But truth of the matter is they just really don't have that individuality. And that's just reality, man. You know, but hold on. Let me find out if I got some more things for Bishop. Yeah, I want to say this too. This is pretty much be the last because I got a lot of shit. But, you know, they did make it known. This is why a lot of shit began to be hard, especially in the city of Chicago. Because you had gang bangers. You had niggas that really didn't have, had no business even having a hoe. Okay? You had niggas who really didn't have no business having a hoe. And these niggas watch Pimps Up Hoes Down. And when Bishop would talk about hanger whoopings, stick whoopings, you know what I mean? You know, when you sit up there and you have a broad and you tell her that you gonna kill her, you gotta damn near go there because, you know, you got to let that bitch know that, you know, you got to make her a believer. You know, if that bitch sit up there and she get out of pocket and, you know what I mean, you tell the bitch that you gonna kill her, you got to let her know, you know what I mean, that you will kill her. You got to go there. You know, you got to go there. You got to damn near kill her. So, you know, hanger whooping, stick whooping. You know what I mean? You got to know that she's a thoroughbred. You got to know that she's ready for the Kentucky Derby. You got to know that she's ready to stand under pressure. You know, so, of course, that's that West Side mentality. I'm letting you know how it is, especially back in the day. And if she could basically sit up there and go to a hanger whooping, stick whooping, gun whooping, you know what I'm saying? If she could go through all of that, you know, you had you a thoroughbred. You really had somebody that was on the team, you know what I mean, that was gonna make sure, you know what I mean, that you was riding all right. 2L man, thank you for the 20. You know, that's how you knew that you had your thoroughbred. So, you know, a lot of the young niggas, Four Corner Hustlers, MCs, Stones, Vice Lords, Crips and Bloods, young niggas all over the world, they looking at Don as the god of the game. So with them listening to rap songs and them seeing this documentary of the man that they see as the top pimp, and you got Snoop Dogg, you know what I mean, praising him as if he's the Allah of the game. Of course, the young people are taking his every word as law, as something pretty much, you know what I mean, to do. You know what I mean? Like, okay, so I got to beat a bitch down to let her know. You know, for real, I'm just being 100. If you a young nigga and you sitting there, I'm just going to put you in the mind frame. I'm walking you through this shit. If you a young nigga, let me get to that part. A lot of young niggas heard this part and was fucked up by it. Surrounded by all these hoes. Hold on. Beating another nigga, just some shit in the gang. Smoking on a fat sack, drinking times I creep. Doing what you think it'd be. 9 times out of 10, the way I live. To farm is hard to swallow. See living down, stopping on a fat sack, drinking on the pain. Oh, hold on. Fuck 'em, then drop 'em, bam. You right. Right. So if you a young nigga and you listening to a song and you like, never have you took their cash, never have you beat their ass. And you constantly listen to that every day, that song begins to minister to your mind. And then you see a documentary with this dude that got rings on every finger that the rappers love and exalt and praise. And you hear him say, you got you stick whooping, hanger whooping, You know what I mean? You got to know that she ready for the Kentucky Derby. You got to know that she's a thoroughbred. You got to know. That's when you knew that you had your hoe that was ready for the track, Jack. Okay, so if you listening to 8 Ball, MJG, Sugar Free, and everybody within these songs, you know what I mean, is basically sitting over there praising, whooping a woman's ass, and then you have a guy who has been glorified to pretty much be the greatest pimp to ever live, preaching, you know what I mean? Well, I mean, not even preaching, because Bishop wasn't telling y'all to do that, but he was testifying about his past. He wasn't telling young pimps to do that, but he was testifying about his past. But by him not putting everything in simplicity, or by Brent Owens not basically, because what you guys got to understand is, a lot of times these directors, they interview a person for 3 or 4 hours, okay? And then they edit all the footage that they had with the individual. So Bishop Don Magic Juan might have put things in simplicity, and he might have sat up there and let it be known that that was incorrect. But to make the movie more marketable, the documentary more marketable, they're going to edit that and probably kick that out and put that in, keep that in, because that makes it more marketable. It'd be a more profitable, you know, film if you basically glorify the nonsense and the ignorance, you know what I mean, of the game rather than the intelligence of the game. So you have to understand, when you watch these documentaries and movies and things like that, a lot of individuals did give clarity about their past. It's just that if we're presiding over a movie, we're not thinking about this guy's representation. We're not thinking about the game. We're thinking about making money, because that's our job, to make millions, okay? We could care less about his pimp representation. All we care is about is the accumulation, some motherfucking money. And we know that black people love ignorance. So if we could push the ignorance of the game, and, you know, who cares about the intelligence? The ignorance is what's going to sell. So, you know what I mean? Bishop might have did give clarity, but it wasn't shown so much in that part. He just talked about, you know, what he did in times past, and by you youngsters not having a mentor, because the scripture says in a multitude of counsel, there is safety. And by you guys having no safety because you have no counsel, you pretty much predestined for destruction, because you're listening to rap songs and you're watching this motherfucking documentary, and you're basically taking heed to it like it's the fucking law or Bible of the game. So basically, you get you a girlfriend, you fuck her good, you eat some pussy, she like you, and you fascinated with the pimp film. You, everything now is pimp this, pimp that, pimp this, pimp that. You don't even want to be around your gang-banging friends no more. They ain't on the same page. You want some money. And then it's like, you know, why sit up there and sell dope and put myself on the front line when I could basically trade in the dope sack and become a Mac and, you know what I mean, basically send her out there to attack for my cash? That's what a lot of niggas thinking. They took the hustle mentality of selling drugs, and they treated the woman just like the motherfucking dope sack. They didn't treat that woman like a woman. They thought because of rap songs and shit that they was hearing, that you basically sit up there and you treat a hoe less than a woman because she's a hoe, which is totally the wrong mentality to have. A hoe is a woman. As a matter of fact, you got to be a woman before you're a hoe. But that's another subject. I know that's going to go over you square. What did he just say? You know what I mean? I'm already knowing, you know, but you have to. Pimps love hoes. Pimps don't hate hoes. Pimps are not individuals because their girlfriend dumped them or their wife divorced them. Oh, man, my wife just divorced me. Oh, man, my girlfriend just left me. I guess I'm mad as hell. I'm about to become a pimp. And you hear these sucker ass testimonies, testifies about this game. And, you know, a lot of you think that pimps basically got inspired to do some pimping just because their girlfriend dumped them or their wife left them. Their wife committed adultery on them, and that's what inspired them to be in the game. As much as I love Sugar Free and love his music, but that interview that he did with Vlad was trash. It was completely garbage. But you do have a lot of individuals who are in the game right now. And the reason for them getting in the game is because their high school sweetheart didn't want to be with them no more. So they was mad at the world. And so now they beating on women and, you know what I mean, all type of shit. And he think that this is pimping. He think that this is, I'm mashing on a bitch. Bitch, shut up. If you even listen to rap songs, they always degrade the hoe. They always minimize the hoe and glorify the square. Even in Messy Marv's music, you know what I mean? Slap my hoe and went and fuck my bitch. I keep it gangster. You know what I mean? If you listen to Messy Marv, it's a song Mess had back in the day, keep it gangster. That's my shit. And, you know, it's that one part, you know what I mean? Smack my hoe and went and fuck my bitch. We keep it gangster. So you smack your hoe and go fuck your bitch. And a lot of you have that mentality. I just get money. My whole bitch. Yeah, my whole bitch. Yeah, I get money from my whole bitch. That's my whole bitch. You know, but that's my real bitch over there. That's wifey over there. This is some goofy shit. That's totally backwards. That is totally backwards. And the reason why a lot of y'all got the game backwards is because you got the so-called game. You didn't get the game. You got the lame. You got the lame from rap songs, and you got the lame from these motherfucking documentaries. They pushed a lot of bullshit in the minds of these young people. So now we got a whole population of lame, sucker-ass motherfuckers that's going to disrespect, minimize the woman, treat her lame as fuck because she's a hoe. And he thinks in order to maintain a hoe, you got to treat a hoe like a damn dog. When in all reality, the hoe is a motherfucking diamond, nigga. And what do with diamonds? You make diamonds shine. You bring your diamonds outside. You treat your diamonds, you know what I mean, valuable because they are valuable. You throw rhinestones across the street. You don't give a fuck about no damn rhinestone. Why? Because it ain't got no value to it. Things of value produce. So you might want to do some observation and examination, you know what I mean, on that woman, man, that you got, that you call your wife or girlfriend, you know, but that's another subject. But a lot of y'all got the game backwards. So, okay, so let me go through this shit because I want to make sure I'm done with Bishop. Okay, yeah, I spoke on that. So, okay, I'm pretty much done with Bishop. Okay, now, Ice-T said some of the most goofiest, lamest, homosexual shit that could ever be said about this here game. And I like Ice-T. Ice-T's cool. He's a legend. You know what I mean? Blessings to him. But reality is, he says some sucker-ass shit and Pimps Up Hoes Down, man. That nigga said, you know, I'm my best hoe. And I've actually heard niggas say this. That they was their best hoe. That they a pimp is a hoe. Before you can become a pimp, you got to be a hoe first. And that's how you teach the hoe how to do some hoeing, because a pimp got to be a hoe first. If that ain't the most homosexual ass shit that I've ever heard in my goddamn life. We do not talk like that. As pimps, we do not say things like, oh, man, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? So when you get started again, oh, man, you know what I mean? I'd never forget, man. It was June of 2007, man. You know what I mean? When I turned out to this shit, man, when I got turned out, you know what I mean, to the pimping. Nigga, I didn't get turned out to the pimping. I was introduced to the game, and because of my individuality, my capabilities, reality is that I was able to produce in the game because of certain characteristics that I have as a man. I was good for the game. But the truth is, I wasn't turned out. That's some old homosexual ass shit. Oh, man, you know, yes, yeah, so when you turn out. Nigga, never, nigga. I never was turned out. That's something that, you know, Tyson Campbell would say. You know, me, I've never been turned out. I was introduced to the game. Once I got the game, I produced in the game because I already had capabilities that made me good for the game. But pimps, we don't say we got turned out. And if you've been saying that, stop saying that shit. You was introduced to the game. You receive introduction to the game, but you never was turned out. I was turned out. We never was turned out. Okay? And a pimp don't be saying, you know what I mean, shit. You know, the reason why I got the best hoes, because, you know, before I started pimping, man, you know what I mean, I was my best hoe. Yeah, man, I was my best hoe, man. You know what I mean? I did some hoeing, you know what I mean, before I started pimping, man. Yeah, man, I was my best hoe. Pimps do not think like that. Hit the like button before I go further. Hit the like button, because you know I'm about to go in. Hit the like button. I gave you some good things, but I got to hit you with the truth. Hit that like button right now. Let's get the likes up. It's 303 people watching right now. Hit the like button. Hit that share button right now. Get that like. Get those likes over 200, man. Hit the likes right now. Everybody hit the like button. So more recommendations for this video. But you know what I mean? This is just, you know, the truth of this game. Nigga, we don't call ourselves hoes. A pimp is not a hoe. A pimp is not his best hoe. Pimp don't catch dates, man. Bitch, a pimp ain't sitting over there selling dick. A pimp is not a prostitute. Bitch, you can't buy no dick from this pimping. You can't sit up there and buy a pimp. No, it don't work like that. Manhood is not for sale. Principles is not for sale, bitch. You know what I mean? No, I'm not going to sit up there and give you my manhood, bitch. I'm not going to give you my balls so I can ball. No, I'm not going to do that. So when Ice-T was sitting in the salon getting his hair done and he said that he was his best hoe, man, real pimps, that make a motherfucker spit out his yak, water, pineapple juice, Jack Daniels, Crown, whatever the hell he drink, that'll make a pimp spit his shit out. I'm my best. What? A hoe? You know what I mean? Pimp ain't catching no dates, man. No, pimp ain't catching no dates, man. You know what I mean? So then I pimped myself, you know what I mean, to basically I put myself. And I know squares was looking like, well, that makes sense, you know. No. In the pimp game, a pimp is not a hoe. Ice-T said some goofy shit. That was terrible. That was abominable. That was laughable. Shouts out to the legend, though. I had to let that be known. I didn't like that. You know what I mean? No. As far as the care of the white folks, I'm not going to speak on white folks because he dead, he gone. So I don't want to get too much, but he said a lot of shit that ain't have. Let me just say that. He said a lot of things that ain't have nothing to do with nothing. Nothing to do with nothing. Okay. The care of the white folks and Pimps Up Hoes Down said nothing profound. Nothing. Only thing that white folks said that I could agree with when he said bitches choosing up with other bitches. I could agree with him on that. You know what I mean? He was dressed, you know, some might say kind of fly. He had on Versace and, you know what I mean? He was doing his thing. You know what I mean? But, No. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? All the bitch got to do is drink from this pimp love potion. No. You know, I'm the engine. All the motherfucking bitch got to do is be the motherfucking caboose. I was like, now, if I was in the video, everybody know me. Anybody that's been watching my videos for a long time, you know that I'm not good at keeping my, you know, expressions when somebody say some shit. So if I was in the room with Scorpio and King James, when he said that shit, I would have been to the side like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'm over like the ocean. You know what I mean? All the bitch got to do is drink some of my pimp's love potion. When he, I just say this. I'm not going to say anything about his character. I'm just talking about the things that were said. And I will say this. Hold on for a minute. When that man, every time, and forgive me for this, but every time, you know what I mean? Hold on. Every time that man would talk, I think this is it. Yeah. Hold on. Hold on. Every time white folks would talk, this is how I would feel.
Day after day, seems like I push against the cloud. They just keep knocking out the sun.
I'm just being real. Every time that man would talk, y'all sitting up, I'm not going to say anything about his character, whether I think he was a pimp or not, but even as a kid, I'm talking about as a teenager, every time that nigga, every time that white person would talk, I'd be like,
day after day, seems like I push up.
Hey, every time that man would talk, I'd be like, man, could he please just stop talking? And you know what really had me fucked up when he would speak is when he actually said, he was like, yeah, you know what I mean? And what I think we should do is have a million men march down in Washington. Uh-huh. Yeah, and what the fuck they gonna do then? Call Ghostbusters? When he said that, when he did that Ghostbusters line, that's when I really was like,
day after day, seems like I push up.
I just got to be real with you. Y'all laughing, but every time he would talk, yeah, we should have a million man Mac march down in Washington. And what they going to do then? Call Ghostbusters? And what upset me and hurt my feelings was I just know when an individual has said something that they think that's profound. Like, I know when he said that, you couldn't tell him nothing. He just knew that that was going to be like the best line within the film. He just knew this, like, I'm going to knock a bitch off this. You know what I mean? Anybody ever seen Mo Money before? If you seen Mo Money with Damon Wayans when he was like, Keith Hennings told me that joke. You know what I mean? At the table. That's what that reminded me of. It's like, dude, man, don't make no more. Don't make no more. Just stop talking, man. Stop talking. I'm not going to say, you know, whether he was a pimp or not. Or I'm just going to say that no. You know what I mean? Like I said, people look at Pimps Up Hoes Down as a tutorial on how to pimp. And I'm here to tell you now, listening to that bullshit is going to cause you to be in jail. You're going to be in somebody's prison, or somebody just might smack the fuck out of you just for being lame as hell. Don't try this outside. Okay. I gotta admit, I gotta tell the truth the way the truth is. Listen, when I was young, and because, you know, I'm in Chicago, man, so what you gotta understand is the crackhead, the preacher, the hustler, everybody in Chicago, when I was coming up, all the OGs, what you got to remember is, as a baby and as a small child, I came up around St. Lawrence. Then we end up moving, you know what I mean, to Hyde Park. So we was in Hyde Park for a while. Then at the Hyde Park, it was 54th and Cottage Grove. At the 54th and Cottage Grove, it was 84th and Dante. So I was moving around all on the south side. So, you know, when my mom got involved with my stepfather, which was GD, but, you know, Dennis was smooth, too. At one time, he could step his ass off, dress good, you know what I mean, and talk well. So his mother stayed on 63rd and Vernon. Everybody knows 63rd and Vernon is right by Parkway. That's where Rothschild's, Liquor Store, all of that shit, right? So You know, when you go into the liquor store to get you some chips and things like that, or get you some snacks and shit, you know what I mean? You always had OGs, you know what I mean, sitting over there talking about some, man, you know, man, what's going on with it, young bub? Hey, what's going on with you, baby? Yeah, what's happening with it, man? Hey, I like your style, youngster. Yeah, man, I really like your style, youngster. I must say, man, you know, whoever your mama is or whoever your father is, man, they doing a real good job. Yeah, they doing a real good job, man. Yeah, they really is. But, youngster, you think, man, that you could spare me a dollar or two? Yeah, man, OG trying to buy some liquor, man. You know what I mean? I'm a little short on this, man. Or, you know, I need just two more dollars, man, to get on the bus. Or I need, man, about two more dollars, man, to sit up there, man, and go in there and get me some of the food and shit, you know. You think you can spare me? And, you know, when I'm coming up, damn near all of the OGs is pretty much talking to you like this. Everybody's smooth. Even the crackheads, even all of them, man. The ones that used to be outside by the liquor store. Hey, you remember? Hey, Risco, you remember that shit, nigga, when we were, nigga, when we was in CVS? Hey, let me clear my voice and shit, nigga, because you knew, nigga, when I used to sing, nigga, the bitches used to be all on me. Lemme, what was that one song we used to sing? Hold on. I only have eyes for you. Then another OG will come in and be like, fool, that ain't had go. It's I only have eyes for you. You know what I mean? Oh, nigga, nah, nigga, you always try to come with that pretty light skin shit, nigga. The bitches was all on me. You know what I mean? So, you know, as a youngster, I always gravitated to older niggas. So when I used to go to the liquor store and I see OGs debating or arguing about sports or arguing about music, I was one of them young kids that always stood by the OGs to try to hear what the fuck they was talking about. You know what I mean? And I used to take the OGs conversation, then I'd go amongst the youth with it. Because listening to the OGs, I got the information. Now I'm able to go amongst the youth and be more knowledgeable than the youth because I got the truth from the OGs. You know what I'm saying? That's how I learned about Mickey Caldwell's. How Mickey was, you know what I mean, eloquent speaking. You know what I mean? Mickey Caldwell was the sharpest speaker among all the leaders. Okay? Chief Supreme Being, Infinite Mind. Larry, a leader amongst the leaders. David, man, was knocking motherfuckers out, left and right. King David was nothing to be played with. King David was knocking, that's the truth. King David was beating the fuck out of niggas. That is the truth. You only gonna learn this by talking to OGs. But Mickey Caldwell was the most eloquent speaking gangster of all of them. You only gonna learn this by talking to the OGs. You're not really gonna get a lot of knowledge about Mickey Caldwell on no damn internet. You gotta be in the city of Chicago. You gotta listen to the OGs. Hit that like button right now. Hit that like button right now. Hit that shares button right now. Break yourself for the likes. Break yourself for the shares, man. You know what I mean? Break yourself. Like, shares, subscribe, all of that shit, man. You know what I mean? But, yeah, I've been hearing the King Von post, but I don't know for sure, so I don't be saying that shit. You know, I don't know. You know what I mean? I know somebody that's really kin to him, but I don't know about King Von. You know what I mean? I don't know. But I said all that to say this. I basically used to love to hear the OGs talk slick. You know what I mean? I used to really love the way the OGs be like, oh man, you know what I'm saying? I had to leave off on that fool, man. What's wrong? Oh man, Joe, you know what I mean? Man, let me tell you something, Finball. You know what I mean? That nigga so motherfucking flugazy. Yeah, man, that motherfucker Bodine, man. He Bodine like a motherfucker. What? Finball, no, man. I think I love, man. I think I had love for that nigga back in the day, man. Because he was really fly. He was doing it, man. Please, man. Man, that nigga, man. That nigga Bodine, man. He bogus, man. He bogus, Mo, man, on air, man. Man, I used to love to hear the OGs talking like that. What's happening with it, Mo? Oh, man, 20 of them, man. What's happening, man? You know what I mean? The Mo's, I just got it. No disrespect to the guys. But when it came to intellect, sharp mouthpieces, that was the Mo's. Man, what's happening, Will? Is it all well, Mo? Man, all is truly well, man. What's happening with it, Mo? You know what I mean? What's happening, Finball? Oh, man, what's going on, right? You know, the Mo's was the one. So when I heard Pimpin' Ken come up in the lounge that time, and he sat up there and was like, oh, man, you know what I mean? All you got to do, man, make let your next move be your best move, and everything will be real smooth around here. You know, me being from the city of Chicago and listening to Slick Talk and listening to the Max, the Players and Pimps and all the OGs at the liquor store and shit like that, I can't even lie to you. Now, of course, it's a lot of things I don't agree with Ken, but all of the youngsters, everybody wanted to talk like Pimpin' Ken. You know what I mean? Because if you grew up in the Midwest, the OGs was already talking like that. So when you basically seen a film and somebody was coming with, you know, some new shit, yeah, you know, Ken say, he I ain't gonna get into that, but Ken is lightweight Milwaukee and Chicago low key. But, you know, the nigga, you know, man, all you gotta do, man, let your next move be your best move, man, and everything could be real smooth. You understand me? You know what I mean? Yeah, you know what I mean? And then especially when it be like, yeah, you know, well, I got a PhD. Oh, well, what is that? You know, Pimpin' Hoes degree. Woo. See, when you a youngster and you endeavoring to be the smoothest nigga, and you want to dress a certain way, you want to smell a certain way, you want to have the best vocabulary, you don't be listening to a bunch of idiots, a bunch of fools. Them niggas that you niggas be listening to that say that they pimps, man, that shit is laughable, man. Them niggas sound like dumbass rappers, man. Them niggas don't be sounding like no motherfucking pimps. But, you know, I was listening to that. You know, and as a youngster, I was like, man, that was slick. I like that. I like that. Then, you know, when he at the bar with the bitch, you know what I mean? She's like, hey, baby, you know what I'm saying? You ready to put, you ready to put Mr. Kool-Aid in your life? The bitch was like, and I ain't gonna lie, you know what I mean? My mama didn't raise me like that, but that's just the truth. You know, you always be attracted to everything contrary to what your mama raised you. Like, my mama didn't raise me to like no stanks, you know what I mean? But that little bitch that Ken was talking to, I like that little bitch, you know what I mean? As a teenager, when she was like, I don't know, why should I? You know what I mean? I've always liked a little ghettified, you know what I mean? Y'all call them thoughts now, you know what I mean? Bust downs and shit. I always liked them. You know what I mean? Period. So, no, we not putting wigs on pigs. No, pimp on women, man. We not fucking with no pigs, no animals, man. You know, women, man. I've never been with that put a wig on a pig mentality because a pimp is number one, and he's endeavoring to be number one. And even when he don't have nothing, he's still number one within his mind. So we would never do the pig with the wig and all of that shit. Like, a lot of these niggas, you know, if it wasn't for ugly bitches, they wouldn't have had nothing because they afraid to talk to attractive women. You know what I mean? So, you know, but that's another subject, though. You know, but for the ugly guys, well, for the guys that really can't spell on a smartphone and shit like that, they like that type of shit, you know, putting wigs on pigs and shit. You know, pimp ain't trying to put no wig on a pig, man. You know, no, man, you know, trying to have something beautiful like Maya up in there, you know what I mean? Mia, you know, who else up in here? I forgot that one little chick's name. You know, something cute like Deja's ashy ass. You know what I mean? That's what a pimp be endeavoring to have, you know, something cute, something attractive that a trick gonna be attentive to, that he gonna spend some money on. You know what I mean? Robin, no, not Robin. No, that's like my crusty little sister, you know what I mean? But Robin cute, you know what I mean? From the side, from the left side, not the right side, but the left. You know what I mean? But that's another subject. But when Ken came at that little broad, You know what I mean? And he get a number and he was like, what's going on, baby? You know what I'm saying? I've been looking at you. I've been looking for you in the daylight with a flashlight. You know, what's going on? You know, I just been handling my business. Baby, what business? Baby, I thought, you know what I'm saying, your business was a pimp's business, baby. You know what I mean? What's going on? I mean, well, we're here, baby. You know what I mean? I ain't gonna motherfucking sweat you. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna get you. I ain't gonna motherfucking need them. I'm gonna let the welfare feed them. Here, you go ahead. You know what I mean? Take this car. You know what I mean? And see, even then, you know, a lot of people thought that I was the one that brought, but no, I'm like, man, pimps been doing limos and business cards and all of that type of shit. Macs and players, gangsters, you know what I mean? Niggas have been having the business card game, but notice, I like that. Kim was set up there and was hit it with the card, like, you know what I mean? Bam. But what I didn't like about that scene, what I didn't like about that scene is when you go back and watch Pimps Up Hoes Down, because I know a lot of y'all are going to watch it after I finish this. When you go back and you watch Pimps Up Hoes Down, what I don't like about it is that fat ass nigga sitting in that damn chair talking about, you're going to choose a pimp, you know what I mean? Choose right, uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? If you're going to choose a pimp, you know what I mean? Choose right, uh-huh. And the bitch is giving this nigga a lap dance. The bitch sitting over there giving this nigga a lap dance, treating this nigga like a trick. She putting her ass against this nigga's dick, and she's sitting over there giving this nigga a lap dance, putting her ass on his dick, and he talking about something. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? If you're going to choose a pimp, you know what I mean? Choose correct. You know what I mean? If you're going to choose a pimp, choose a pimp. So, no, I wasn't feeling that, partner. You know what I mean? That was looking crazy. That was looking very crazy. You know what I mean? This nigga looked like the trick. You know what I mean? He looked like the tricking, but he got pimping coming out of his mouth. I didn't like that. I didn't dig that part at all. You know. Okay, I deal with that. Now, let me deal with this. Okay? These are the things that I didn't agree with in the film. Okay? This is where Pimpin' Ken, you know, goes wrong, okay? Because when Pimpin' Ken riding in the car, he says, yeah, you know, it take a certain type of woman, you know, to be in the lifestyle. Matter of fact, I don't even want it to just come out my mouth. Hold on, give me a second. You know, it take a certain type of woman to be, you know, in the lifestyle. She gotta be abused, all of this goofy shit. Hold on, I don't want me just saying it. I actually want you to see something for yourself. But that part right there was very goofy. See, they got different versions on here and shit. See, what you want to watch, you want to watch the director's cut when you watch it. Hold on, I'm still looking for that part. But yeah, I didn't agree with that one bit. Okay, yeah, it's coming up. Hold on for a minute.
That's the fee that they paying, you know, for the game.
Choose
right. A lot of hoes that's out here, they choose. You know, when they get with a pimp, you know, it's by choice. It ain't by force. It takes a certain kind of woman, though. You know, ain't no any woman just gonna give you money. You can't go up in Walgreens and a woman see you and she like you and you ask her, you say, say, baby, give me your money. No, it don't happen like that. It takes a woman that has a certain amount of abuse. She's been through some things. You know, she probably was raped by her brother or her father, and she have a very low self-esteem. She don't feel no worth, so she try to buy worth. She try to get worth in a man. And a lot of times, they see a man, an older man, he don't necessarily have to be dressed nice, he don't necessarily have to be handsome, but they see that father figure, they be trying to get that father image from that man. And she believe that she gonna give us some security and some direction. A pimp try to do everything in his power to keep a woman from looking at another man or from choosing another man. Because if your woman look at another pimp and she like him, then that means that your money stopped.
So
that's how you doing.
Hold on.
You looking all fine, everything.
Now, you heard it out of his mouth when he said, woman got, and he gonna say some more things even later on that I was like, no, that ain't it, man. No. Why would you say some shit like that, especially knowing that these motherfucking squares gonna see that shit, man, and eat that all up. And they gonna try to categorize this game with the shit that you saying, man. And that ain't it, man. Why are you sitting over there lying on the truth? Maybe you wasn't lying, because maybe you actually thought that this shit was the truth. But let me tell you. Okay, there are women. I'm not going to negate the fact that there are actually women who have been raped, molested, you know what I mean, mentally, physically, spiritually abused, who have come into the game. And I don't see anything wrong with that, because it was the game that took a lot of women who had low self-esteem and empowered them and made them the embodiment of boldness. In areas where they were shy and timid, you know what I mean? They didn't know how to initiate a conversation after receiving the uncommon information of this game. That's what liberated their ass. The game set up there and made these women confident. A lot of these women had ass, titties. They were gorgeous. But because they were called ugly all their motherfucking life, they actually believed that they were ugly. It was the game that brought the revelation of the true vision of their appearance. So I don't look down on the women who've been came through that, and you know, they were depressed and you know, they were hurt. You know what I mean? They didn't receive enough attention from their father and mother. You know what I mean? The congregation didn't sit up there and, you know, bless them. You know, they didn't get that. They didn't get that at all. So, you know, with that being said, you know, I'm not saying that, but to make that as if that's a prerequisite to be in the game, that's wrong. That is falsified information. That is wrong. Okay? You don't have to be molested, raped, or be abused, you know what I mean, mentally, you know what I mean, to finally sit up there and agree with the pimping. No. Like, oh my God, and you know, first time I had, you know, sex was with my father and uncle. I'm not saying that those stories don't exist, because they do. But don't make it like every woman within the lifestyle was fatherless, friendless, loveless, and that's the reason why they got in the game. That is false. That is very false. That's false. Because you got women who come from two-parent homes. They come from religious homes. They got a college background like my mother. My mother graduated from Wilberforce University, got a 4-year bachelor's degree in education. But even with that 4-year degree of being educated, because she got her 4-year degree in education at Wilberforce University in Dayton, Ohio, that didn't stop my mother from being a hoe. That didn't stop my mother from being a hoe. And one thing I love about my mother, when she would preach and testify about the mercies of God and bringing her in true holiness, my mother never hid the fact that, you know what I mean, she was a hoe. I love that about my mother. You know what I mean? That's probably why I'm as bold as I am, because of Marita Mayberry. But having an education, having a religious background, coming from a two-parent home, a one-parent home, that don't mean that, you know what I mean, this individual ain't going to be in the game. That person might want to be in the game because they think that they would be actually successful or more powerful in the game simply because they have an education. And then what you have to realize, because y'all put so much importance on the pimp and hoe relationship, not realizing that it's really between that man and that woman. And that woman is going to conform to whatever lifestyle that man is involved in. So if that man is involved in the lifestyle of pimping and hoeing, and she really likes that man like that, she feeling that man like that, she want that man like that, guess what? She gonna do this and that for that man. So whether he's a gangster, whether he's a Muslim, or whether he's a pimp, or whether he, whatever the fuck he doing, blood, crip, motivational speaker, preacher, teacher, whatever the hell he is. If that woman really likes that man, she gonna conform to the lifestyle that that man is involved in, and she gonna evolve with that man that she's involved with, period. So, you know, all of this, you know, you gotta be raped, it take a certain type of woman to give you her money. This is false, because I've presided, as a matter of fact, some of y'all done seen the court video. The woman that's sitting on the stand that said that, you know, he's not what you think he is and all that. The Gigi bra, she's college educated. I wasn't attracted to her, never had sex with her, but I can't deny that. Mentally, she's one of the smartest, if not the smartest, woman that I've ever had as far as education is concerned. This woman knew how to fly planes. Okay, spoke, you know what I mean, 5 different languages fluently, you know what I mean, grew up in Islam, you know, got her master's at the University of Illinois. So miss me with all of this education, you know, she went to this school, so she ain't gonna talk to a pimp. She went to this school, she got 2 parents, oh, she believes in Jesus, so she's not gonna sell her pussy. That's a goddamn lie. And I don't even want you to bring that devilation, you know what I mean, in this congregation at all. That is a lie. This game is not limited. It reaches the utmost, you know what I mean? It goes far and beyond. So whether you believe in Jesus, Yahshua, Allah, you know what I mean, Yahweh, man, the Pope, whatever your belief is, that don't mean that this bitch can't get knocked. Why? Because every big head ass bitch is knockable. And just because I didn't knock her, he didn't knock her, or he didn't knock her, maybe they had the right presentation and information when they was endeavoring to have a conversation with that woman. But when they did it, it was the wrong time. Everything with women is about timing. Just because she's educated, that don't mean that she ain't the embodiment of emotions. And sometimes you can't help who you like. Sometimes you can't help who you call yourself falling in love with. You know what I'm saying? And you just might really like, extremely like a pimp. You know? You might really love sincerely, earnestly, on a daily, possess an authentic love for a pimp. You know? Yeah, it can happen. Because it's happened many times. Because my mama was in love with my father, and everybody knew what my father was all about. You know what I'm saying? So miss me with all of that. She got to do that. That's false information. Okay, moving on. Because I'm walking you all throughout the film. Because it was a lot of abominable, dumbass shit that was in there. Yeah, she been raped, low worth, so she tried to buy her worth in a man and all of that. That's why I had to say that. Yeah, and I also have to speak about, see, I love my city, okay? I'm a Chicago nigga, okay? But I'm glad, I'm so glad that even though I'm a Chicago nigga, that I was introduced to the game. The game blessed me to be introduced to the game on the West Coast. So I pretty much got the best of both worlds. Even though I'm from Chicago, you know, I didn't start until I came to the West Coast. You know, I started in Vegas, but things really got moving when I came to Southern California. Okay? And because my mentality is different than the usual participant that's from Chicago, ain't no such thing as a woman pimp. Okay? Ain't no such thing as a woman pimp. I'm going to say that again. I know a lot of y'all going to go, what? Ain't no such thing as a woman pimp. After watching Pimps Up Hoes Down, a lot of you big head bitches thought that it was cool for you to profess this pimping. And I'm here to let you know that that's falsified information. There is no such thing as a goddamn female pimp. The only thing that can happen is you're presiding over a female who's ignorant, that can't discern the difference between authentic and fraudulent. And paying a woman that's professing to be a pimp, that's fraudulent. There is no such thing as a female pimp. You out of bounds. You out of bounds. And see what I loved about my Father's Day? Because you had some bitches that actually tried to do what this pimping do. Because just like in everything in life, women always try to do what a man can do. She always want to feel equal. But bitch, God didn't make you equal. Sit down. The thing is, in my Father's Day, especially in the city of Chicago, if a bitch had a bitch or bitches, guess what happened? You know what I mean? A pimp or even a group of pimps, especially if he had mob ties, if he was blessed in any organization, in any mob, that's why I say, even when you get involved in the pimping, of course, gangbanging don't mix, you know what I mean, with this pimping. But at the same time, you know what I mean? What does, you know, if you're a gang member and you come out of an organization or you come out of a gang, that's why it's still cool to basically stay in touch with your loved ones. Because say, for example, if extraordinary gentleman and my nigga Goldie and Clips, we all on the west side. And we all on the blade on the west side. And as we on the blade, we seeing this bitch or bitches that got bitches down on the track. And motherfuckers know how I'm going to get out. You know what I mean? I ain't going to say nothing. Especially if we're on the west side, because I'm plugged in with certain ones. So the wise thing to do, instead of me putting my hands on this bitch that thinks she a man, that think that she just pimping, either you can, you know, because I've seen a lot of them guys try to even pimp at the bitch, and the bitch might get disrespectful and all that old goofy shit. But especially if she get disrespectful with the pimping, just sit up there and jump right on the line. What's happening? What's going on with you, man? Oh, man, I can't call it like a blind referee. What's happening? Yeah. But yeah, Finball, man, I wanted to sit up there, man, and give you this demonstration, man. Where you at? Yeah. Look, check this out. You already know I want you to do a favor for me. It's as simple as that. You know what I mean? And by this bitch not having a pimp, especially a renegade or a bitch that thinks she a pimp, you sit up there, you don't put your pimp don't make provisions to put itself in jail, okay? Just like, you know what I mean, that you sit up there, you understand me, and send a hoe, you know what I mean, you can send a bitch. That's how you sit up there, you understand me, and you can sit up there and send your niggas. I'm not making niggas equivalent to bitches, but I'm just saying, you know, a pimp, basically, y'all always say it's chess, not checkers. Okay, in the game of chess, you know what I mean, you already know how a king move. King don't be moving all around. You know what I mean? King send that bitch. So I said all that to say this. You know what I mean? Once them, whether you tied in with the foes, via whatever. Once your headbusters come through there and you done gave them the demonstration, the whole demo of what you want to be laid down. Hey, man, that bitch gonna fuck around and get a pumpkin head, man. She about to get robbed around this motherfucker. Yeah, see, a lot of them renegades, you know what I mean? They're real comfortable now. You got renegades on the E14. You got renegades on Bissonette. You got renegades on Fig. You know what I mean? It's because these laws is catering to these renegades and all these faggot ass bitches. But you know what I mean? Especially, you know what I mean? Back in the day, hey, man, you know what I mean? Nigga can sit up there, you know what I mean, and comb a bitch head and take it to the barbershop, you know what I mean, like he was supposed to for, you know, doing things contrary to this game. But nowadays, I just think it's best that a pimp stay out the way so he can endeavor to keep having it his way and let a goon be a goon. Let a goon be a goon. Meaning that you don't make provisions for you to put yourself in jail and prison. You let a goon be a goon. You let that goon go upside her head. So, you know what I mean? A lot of them bitches that was renegades, they ended up choosing up on the motherfucking pimping. Why? Because they got tired of getting robbed. They got tired of getting their head beat the fuck in. You know what I mean? You might have one nigga, because you already know on the west side of Chicago, bitches be dating niggas. So, you know what I mean? This gangster that's pretending like he about to sit up there, and I told you, y'all got to tap it out and tap right back in. You know what I mean? But, you know, this gangster that's pretending to be a trick, he about to do some tricking on this bitch. In reality, he really about to take this bitch to a secluded area and beat her motherfucking head in for disrespecting this pee. See, the reason why a lot of bitches feel comfortable with calling pimps bitches and being disrespectful, because ain't nobody putting that demo down no more. Ain't nobody putting down that demonstration down no more. If that demonstration went down, you would see bitches giving the utmost respect. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna call no names and things like that, but I know some individuals that still move like that and they still honor. You won't see no bitches sitting over there calling that man a bitch or getting disrespectful. When you go to certain blades, you holler at certain bitches because they fucking with certain gangbangers. When you holler at the bitch, bitch sitting over there cussing you out, talking about this on Crip or, you know what I mean, on Larry and all of this goofy shit. You know what I mean? That's because ain't nobody putting that demonstration down. See, once that demonstration go down, that bitch get a motherfucking head comb. You know what I mean? Because bitch, I'm about to call my nigga. Well, bitch, call him. You know what I mean? But we still got time before he get here. So what you think was about to happen, you know what I mean, until he get here? Because you about to get your ass beat. You know what I mean? And niggas was serious about they pimping, you know what I mean, like that, back in the G. But all of that shit and Pimps Up Hoes Down with these bitches presiding over bitches like they was doing some pimping, man, that shit was disgraceful. That shit was abominable, man. That shit was terrible. That shit was full of confusion. Hey, sunshine, you know what I mean? But no, a lot of y'all got a lot of devilations from the motherfucking documentary, seeing women with women and presiding over women and all that old goofy shit. Bitch talking about she about to open up a cookie shop and all of this shit with a bitch and all that old dumbass shit. Yeah, a lot of y'all, let me go to the names. I think Lexus and all of this old dumbass shit. And because we in a confused world and lesbianism, homosexuality is being glorified to the highest degree, they done took something that's supposed to be abnormal and made it normal to society. Then they sat up there and brought it to the pimping hoe society, and they want women to be presiding over women and shit. That's confusion. That is confusion. A woman ain't got no damn business presiding over a woman. And bitch, if you walking up and down motherfucking blades, sucking and fucking on trick after trick, inside a car after car, going to resort after resort, casino after casino, and turning your money over to a goddamn woman, bitch, you a motherfucking fool. You sitting over there going through all your emotional turmoils. You sitting over there, you know what I mean, going through, you know what I mean, all of these emotions and shit. And then when this bitch is supposed to sit up there and encourage you and pick you up when you down, she emotional with you. So it's two emotional motherfuckers. You know what I mean? Two emotional motherfuckers. One, this bitch is more emotional than this one, but she supposed to be the pimp. Hey, that's one of the biggest reasons why a woman could never be this pimping is because she is a woman. And no matter how hard she dress, no matter how hard she fuck when she got the dildo on, no matter how hard she try to act, no matter who she killed, no matter if she beat up a nigga or beat some niggas' asses, at the end of the motherfucking day, she cannot change how the Most High made her. She's still a woman. She is still a woman. And in most cases in the game, you know what I mean? That's why, as the great incomparable Mel Taylor said, you got to be a man first, meaning that there are going to be some circumstances and situations that go come into this game. And you got to mentally respond to it like a motherfucking man. You can't emotionally react to it like a woman. You got to mentally respond to these situations like a man. And if you cannot do that, you're not going to be, you know, pimp. You're not going to be pimp. You have to mentally respond. You can't be in your emotions and feelings and shit like that. So all these bitches putting on an Oscar award performance, acting as if they can be this pimping, man, that shit is comedy. That's more funnier than Cat Williams' first stand-up. Bitch, that is not, that you are not the pimping. And you'll never be the pimping. But seeing, I seen this bitch, and one time she was three deep. And I seen another bitch, and she was four deep. So what do you call that? What did Jesus say? The blind leading the blind. Just like you got niggas that's living off the distributes of a prostitutes, and they tricks, because you do got tricks, they got prostitutes. You got gangbangers and strangers to the game, they got prostitutes that's receiving distribution. You know what I mean? So I see basically a woman presiding over women, you know, pretty much in the same category as a trick having a bitch or a gangbanger having a damn bitch. It's the same thing. You out of bounds. That shit is out of bounds. A woman ain't got no business paying another woman. And all you niggas with all of this funny ass new style of pimping that you got going on, you know, this young dro pimping. My girlfriend got a girlfriend. Chevy Blue, like all you, my girl got a girlfriend, the P ass niggas, you know, where you got the bitches licking on each other and all of that to fulfill all your little fantasies, because a lot of you niggas got fetishes and shit. You know what I mean? You ain't doing nothing but making this bitch more gayer. You making a fag evolve. That's all you doing. You creating a fag, and you basically giving her encouragement to be a motherfucking bigger fag. Oh, man, you know what I'm saying? I seen one video with some old corny ass nigga sitting down with two bitches. And one bitch, she's sitting over there kissing on one bitch. And she's sitting over there looking like she getting ready to taste the bitch and all of this shit. And this nigga thought it was pimpish. He say, oh, man, you know what I mean? Don't never mind that, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man. The bitch, man, you know what I mean? She just owed the bitch, man. You know? Yeah, yeah. She paying back a little debt. You know? Yeah, she just paying back a little debt, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man, you know what I mean? So, yeah, we can get back to this interview, man, because she just paying a little dead. What? Man, that shit was gay as hell. You know what I mean? Gay as hell. You know what I mean? Gay as hell. Like I said, a lot of you niggas got that young dro shit with you. My girlfriend got a girlfriend. Chevy Blue Like Whirlwind. Good looking Christian. Thank you for the $1, man. A whole bunch of ones beat a whole bunch of nuns any day, baby. Good luck. Okay, so we know that there are no female pimps, and I just didn't like that. I wouldn't even want to participate in a fucking film that got a bitch receiving an award as this pimping. I would have never participated in no damn Pimps Up Hoes Down. I would have never been in no damn film where a woman is getting an award for this pimping. You know what I mean? Never. Because it was a total disgrace. Hit the like button right now. It's 322 people watching. Hit the like button right now. Okay, let me go through some more. I really don't have too much to say about King James. King James was decent. You know what I'm saying? With a little blackjack. You know what I mean? I like when he said, you know, you got to pimp from your mind. You know what I mean? Yeah, we have our fun. Meaning that, you know, pimps do have sex with their hoes. But at the same particular time, you know, we don't be getting into a continuity of fucking a bitch all day, every day. You know what I mean? A pimp is a pimp. You know what I mean? He's not a porn star. You know what I mean? So a nigga can have a motherfucking little penis and still be a genius. You know what I'm saying? About this motherfucking pimping. You know what I mean? Nigga can have a big ass dick. You know what I mean? And still not have no game. Then a nigga can have a big ass dick, but because he governed by the rules and regulations of his game, he don't basically use his sword to try to maintain the mind of a woman. Now, when, you know, it got to go down, and when he got to sit up there, you know what I'm saying, and make reservations and create email addresses in that pussy, you know what I mean, he do his thing, you know what I mean? But a pimp gonna fuck you so different than a square. You know what I'm saying? It's a difference from when squares fuck and a pimp fucking. Okay? I'm going to do a video about that, you know what I mean? Because I know a lot of y'all want it, and you've been wanting it for a while. But it's a difference between getting fucked by a square and getting fucked by a pimp. You know what I mean? A pimp, you know what I mean, fucking, you know what I mean, is one of the greatest experiences sexually that a woman can experience. Okay? Because before a pimp stick his dick, you know what I mean, inside you, he gonna give you some of the best mental climaxes that you've ever had in your life. And he's gonna satisfy you mentally. You know what I mean? And a lot of you women, you're sapiosexual women, and you be in need of, you know, a mental climax. And talking to an intelligent, well put together, clean man is just so hard to find. So when you can find an individual that you attracted to, and y'all get involved in a conversation, and y'all going on a mental safari with one another, and he's sitting over there just giving you revelation after revelation, he's able to answer all your questions the same way that King Solomon was able to answer Queen Sheba. He has mentally fucked you, spiritually fucked you, emotionally fucked you. He got you so wet that, you know what I mean, even, you know, before he even stick his dick in, you damn near ready to come. You know what I mean? A pimp fucking. You know what I mean? You already mentally, on a daily, already thought about this man being inside of you. You know what I mean? And you just love, you know what I mean, for it to enjoy this powerful individual that is greater than money. You know, because a pimp is greater than money. He can't even be governed by green papers with dead hypocrites on it. You done met an individual that pussy doesn't control. He is more powerful than pussy. He's not a slave to that. He's not a victim to that. He's not a trick to that. He's above that. And to be able to talk to this man that's not moved, or his moves ain't dictated, you know, about whether or not you're going to suck his dick or fuck him. And he not pulling on you every 2 seconds like, when we going to fuck? You know what I mean? I know you had a bad day, but, you know, when we going to fuck? You know what I'm saying? He's not that. He's fly. He's special and peculiar, and he ain't regular and familiar like the rest. Okay, he's always bringing enlightenment. He's always bringing something comical. He make you laugh. He make you smile. He make you think. He produces certain information that makes you want to be a better woman. He's really a man. He stimulates you mentally. And when it comes time for that man to reside in the bag, in the pussy, you know what I mean? It's great because you already mentally was there. You already was emotionally there, and pretty much, just to keep it 100, he done told you about the author of this book. He gave you words in the dictionary that you never heard before, and it just sounded so beautifully, you know, proceeding out of his tongue. You know what I mean? And he was telling you about the Bible, then he told you about history, then he talked about music with you, talked about fashion with you. You know what I mean? And then, when you tried to fuck him, he denied you. And not because he wasn't attracted to you, because you're very beautiful and he would love to be inside of you, but he basically didn't accept the cards that had been dealt by society. He basically changed the hand, because that's too much power for a woman to have to decide on when we gonna bless each other, when we gonna exchange spirits, because that's what sex is. It's an exchange of spirits, whether you believe it or not. So before we get involved, you know, spiritually, physically, I have to fuck you mentally. I have to fuck you emotionally. Because some of you women, the way that you're built, you can't even reach an orgasm without a man mentally and emotionally even going there with you first. Some of you are just built like that. A guy can have a 11-inch dick. He can have a cold tongue and you'll feel good, you know. But the reality is you would never come because he didn't make you mentally come up first. So because he didn't make any mental deposits mentally, then, you know, physically, it ain't going to go down for you, you know, like that. Because some of y'all are really built like that. You have to mentally be satisfied before you, you know, reach an orgasm with your pussy. Not every woman, but some are really like that. You have to fuck them like that. They need a pimp fucker, you know. So that's why I say it's a difference with that. And, you know, when you go into the film, you know, it really wasn't, you know, profound. A lot of these women, they speak down on men because reality is they never had an encounter with a man. You know what I mean? Niggas ain't shit. Men ain't shit. Reality is she never met a man. All she knows is males in the bodies of men who conduct themselves like females when situations and circumstances come. So, you know, it's logical why they speak down on pimps, on men, because in reality, they never met a man, you know, and it's really nothing. And pimps are posed down to see a woman presiding over a woman simply because a lot of women gave different men opportunities to preside over them in the game, and they all failed. All the males that profess to be men, all the males that profess to be pimps failed these women. And a lot of these women are love starved, attention starved. And so sensitivity is a necessity for a lot of them. So they rather be around a woman who's more sensitive, you know, to them. And they gravitate to sensitivity. So if you just, oh, man, fuck all that shit, man. We mashing on a bitch, man. All that sensitive shit. If the bitch want all the sensitivity, bitch, then go find motherfucking Ralph Trez, man. I'm beating hoes head in. If you one of them type of niggas, you're not really going to have success with them type, that crowd of women that I'm talking to. She going to end up paying a woman. So we have to change our mentality. We have to stop treating that. When I say we, I'm speaking as a whole. You can't treat a hoe lesser than a woman. Because reality is, the reason why a lot of y'all traps ain't shit because you treat your hoe or hoes like they ain't shit. And then you expect them to bring you all of this shit when they come in and you sent the bitch out of the door feeling like she ain't shit. So when she talked to a trick, she like, hi, what's going on? 100 for head, 150 for pussy. Excuse me, I can't hear you. 100 for BJ and 150, you know, for pussy. Are you trying to buy or not? Seriously, this is the type of individuals that these niggas is sending out the door. And I am tired of them doing documentaries where they got women sitting over there crying. And you know what I mean? I think this one shit was called Tricked. And every woman on there was just, you know, and I just remember just running away from my mom's home. And I really didn't want to be in the lifestyle. It's just that my mom, she moved her boyfriend in, and I didn't want to be there. So, you know, I met this guy and he had all these rings on and a suit, and he said he can just change my life. And I was like, well, I've never done that before, but, you know, will you treat me nice? Will you be good to me? And he said that I'm going to be your father. I'm going to be your mother. I'm going to be your sister. I'm going to be your brother. And I did not know what I was going to get myself into. Then it's a white man, as the, he narrates, sweet little Mary did not know that she was going to get involved with one of the most notorious pimps, Pimp Slap a Hoe Down, out of Oakland, California. And, you know, at first he just told me his name was Steven. I didn't know that his name was Pimp Slap a Hoe Down. You know, he just told me that he was a nice guy, and, you know, we ate, and, you know, he made me laugh. He was just so sweet in the beginning, and one day he just told me to pack up, and he told me what we were going to be going doing, but he didn't tell me, you know, where we were going. And I said, where are we going? He said that I'm going to the E14. We're going to hit Oakland. And I never knew anything about that place. And when I got there, it was just so scary. It was just so terrifying. Sweet little Mary did not know that she was going to be on the mean streets of the E14 in Oakland, California. Then they're going to show all these Ritalin baby ass niggas in there. Yeah, man, we from the town, man, where you beat a bitch head in to get your ends, man. Yeah, man, sitting over there, you understand me, kidnapping bitches, man, putting them in the back of trunks to do a motherfucking shack slam dunk, you know what I mean, in this motherfucking gang, bitch. You know what I mean? Really sliding in the hoes, Mento, knocking bitches from Sacramento to motherfucking Frisco, nigga, from the yay to the bank. You know what I'm saying? This is how we doing this shit, man. You know what I mean? Hey, man, nigga gotta go through incidents with this shit, accidents with this shit, motherfucking mistakes, but a nigga ain't gonna break like a motherfucking frosted flake, you know what I'm saying, in this gang, man. You know what I'm saying? Nigga, you know what I'm saying, really get up, you know what I mean, really pimped up, pimped the fire, you know, with the shit, you know what I mean? Hey, man, you know what I mean? When I see these bitches and shit, man, I let the bitch know, man, you know what I mean? You got an opportunity or it's gonna be a discrepancy, man, you know what I mean? Because I don't play with a bitch, man. You know, I'm really out. They be calling these other niggas Captain Save a Hoe, but a real pimp, man, is really Captain Save a Hoe, man, because I'm motherfucking saving the hoe from my motherfucking goddamn self, nigga. If you really must know, nigga. Yeah, nigga, I'm from the Yay. And, of course, you gotta look at it from a squares point of view. If you're a white person, or you're a person that, you know, call yourself educated, and you're watching this documentary, you're gonna be like, wow, so these are the pimps? Wow, that sweet girl, she don't know nothing about, oh my God, what type of name is that? Pimp Slap a Hoe Down. Oh my God, this is just so terrible. I didn't even know that this world existed. Oh my God, look at how they're taking advantage of. Oh my God, I'm so annoyed with this. This is disgusting. These despicable individuals. Oh my God, come on, Lordy. Lordy, oh, come on, Lordy. You know what I mean? Real talk, you always gotta look at things from a squares point of view. And if you got all of these clowns, if you got, you know, yeah, you know, all the bitch got to do is be the engine and be the motherfucking caboose. Yeah, I'm all about the pimp social. All the bitch got to do is jump in my pimp's little potion. If you got that going on, then yeah, I can understand. Hit the like button right now. Everybody hit the like button. Everybody hit the share button. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, make sure you subscribe to the channel right now. Hold on, let me finish going through my shit. Yeah, so we know it's no female pimps. That should have never been in the film. To all of you that are novices or you're just ignorant pertaining to the game, there's no such thing as a female pimp. Tony, thanks for coming in with the 10. Blessings, bro. I think the nigga Jay came in. Hold on, before I go any further, let me hold on, let me take my shit up. Come on, man, hit that like button. Let's get some more people up in here. Jay shit left, but I know Jay had gave me something, man. Blessings to Jay. Blessings to Tony, man. I thank you guys, man. But you know what I mean? That's just real shit. There's no female pimps. Pimps is not hoes. It was just a lot of abominable shit that was being said in Pimps Up Hoes Down, man. It really gave you niggas the game backwards. Okay, yeah. One thing I like about King James, if you peep out King James did say this. I forgot about this point. He said that basically he takes his hoes to the hospital to make sure that he's not selling a rotten product. Okay, and you know, a lot of you A woman could tell you that, you know, she been raped by a trick. Oh my God, you know, oh my God, where are you? Where are you? What's going on, bitch? Oh my God, I just was raped. I just got raped right quick. I don't know what happened. I was letting him hit it from the back. Next thing I know, you know what I mean? He took the condom off. So he nutted inside you? Okay, bitch, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna take you to the hospital, you know what I mean? First thing first when you get up in. When the truth really was, you know, especially a bitch that was taking care of herself before she even met you, or if she's a square especially, and she just had an encounter with a trick, and he didn't sit up there and put a hole in the condom or took the condom off, you know what I mean, while the bitch was sitting over there, you know what I mean, letting the trick get him, you know what I mean, in the back, he was doing this thing. Hey, man, you know, and a lot of you niggas, you were so concerned, you know what I mean, about your money that you didn't give a fuck, you know what I mean, about whether or not she got raped or not. And that's when she knew that she was pretty much just a machine. She was just a robot for you. She wasn't really somebody of importance. You didn't have any concern, you know what I mean, for the woman, you know what I mean, at all. So, you know, a lot of y'all really not pimps, because one thing about pimps care about hoes. You know what I mean? Okay, I can keep watching you talk like a few. I don't know what he's on. Okay, yeah, and I know you out. Yeah, and with that being said, don't worry. You out for good now. You know, blessings to you. But, you know, just keeping, you know what I mean, one thing all the way 100. If a woman basically, you know what I mean, going through all of that shit that she going through, and you sit up there, you know what I mean, and you respond like that, the woman pretty much knows that, you know what I mean, she just some money to you. That's all she means to you. It's just some money. So when King James said that was a very good look, you know what I mean, for the game, and it's true. Real pimps, you know what I mean, sit up there and they take their women to the hospital to get them examined, you know what I mean, take to the clinic, you know what I mean, to get checked up, you know what I mean, to get that examination, you know what I mean, and then it makes the woman feel secure because she's messing with a man that actually really cares about her health, her well-being, you know what I mean, her spiritually, emotionally, you know what I mean, as a woman. So yeah, I could definitely respect that, you know what I mean, coming from King James, you know? Hold on. Yeah, that was another thing that Ken had said that, you know, I wasn't feeling when Ken had made the statement saying that a woman accepts being disrespected. You know, she accept being, he said, demeanored as a woman and all of this shit. I'm pretty sure if he can go back, maybe he would change some of these statements that he made in the film. But this was garbage. That was garbage. You know, throw that away. That was garbage. You know, she got to go. It takes a certain woman to accept being disrespected and disrespected. You know, pimps don't even talk like that. Disrespected as a woman. You mean by the guys who ain't really pimps? Because, you know, pimps actually really love and respect their hoes. Now, if you basically speaking from a square's perspective, you have to basically let it be known to the squares that, you know, within the lifestyle that, you know, you have pimps who open the door for their hoes. You got pimps that cook for their hoes. You got pimps, you know what I mean, that actually encourage their hoes. They work out with their hoes in the gym. They inspire their hoes to read. You can't categorize the pimping as a bunch of, you know, riddling babies who basically just be beating on bitches for no reason and shit. You know what I mean? And being, they disrespect them and all of that. That was very square. That was very, that wasn't it. You know, that wasn't it. That wasn't it. Touch somebody and say that wasn't it. Yeah, another time when you really saw that Alexis bitch was not a man, You know what I mean? Because it take a man to be this pimping. It's when Lexus sat up there and told that bitch six times. Now, if you watch the film, a Lexus bitch is going to get into a verbal confrontation with Pimpin' Ken's bitch. And they both going back and forth at it. And the Lexus bitch tells the bitch six times to come on, let's go. Come on, let's go. And the bitch still doing her thing. See, that's the difference from a man and a motherfucking woman. When a man tell another man or woman, whatever the fuck, that he's the leader of, when he give instructions, these instructions will be followed the first motherfucking time. Ain't no six times, come on, come on, come on, let's leave, come on, come on. So that lets you know right then and there, you know what I mean, that this is a bitch. This is what happens when a bitch is running shit. Shit ain't being done right. Bitches feel like they can do any motherfucking thing because she listening to a bitch. You know what I mean? Even when, you know what I mean, which I'm going to get to that. Even when Snooki was sitting over there sweating, I think her name was Moet, and he was sweating that bitch. You know what I mean? That bitch was giving that nigga hella action. Look how the bitch sat up there and even told the bitch. And he got rings on his finger, kings on. Damn, bitch, you looking at the appearance of a pimp? You all on, you all, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. You all, you looking at the rings? That bitch had to hurry up and get that bitch away from Snooki, because the truth is, Snooki was getting ready to have that bitch, because she was looking like she was mesmerized. I'm just telling it like it is. Regardless of whether or not, you know, of course, I'm going to get to all of that, but I'm just telling the truth in totality. I'm not just giving you the negativity. I'm giving you the positivity as well. And at that particular time, especially when we saw Snooki in that film, oh, man, we just knew that this was a diehard, hardcore, no hoes bar, no making no deals, smashing on a bitch. All of the niggas, they wanted to talk like Ken, but they wanted to mash on a bitch like Snooki, though. Even though on the front cover is Bishop Don Magic Wand, Snooki, well, I just tell the truth. Snooki was the star of the film. He was the star of the film. That's why it was hurtful to see him basically snitch and then admit to the shit and say that it wasn't rat shit, it was Mac shit. That was abominable. But I'm going to get to all of that, right? So, you know, the bitch sat up there and told that bitch six times, you know, let's roll. Bitch ain't roll. That lets you know what I mean? When a bitch running shit, that's the difference between a man and a woman. Man ain't about to sit up there and go six times saying, bitch, let's leave, let's leave, let's leave, let's leave. Somebody would have got the furniture smacked up out their mouth by now. Hold on for a minute. Yeah, one of my favorite parts of the film is when Scorpio is sitting down with his hoes. You know what I mean? And when Scorpio sat up there and said, you know what I mean? Ain't nothing that I love most than a happy hoe. You know what I'm saying? As long as you happy, you know what I mean? I'm all right. You know what I mean? And one thing I like about, you know, because a lot of y'all had the nerve to try to speak down on Scorpio because you seen him in Pimps Up Hoes Down because in the place that they were staying in at that particular time. But it's a lot. I ain't going to speak on it, but it's a lot that was going on at that time that a lot of y'all don't know about. But anybody that's in these streets, they pretty much know, you know what I mean, Scorpio's representation in the streets. When it comes to having money in the game and producing some of the greatest thieves that, you know what I mean, have ever lived, you have to bring Scorpio's name up within the conversation. You know what I mean? I'm not talking about now. I don't know, you know, about him being active and all that. You know, he's a businessman. But as far as back then, at this time in the 90s, yeah, you know what I mean? He was known as that dude. Especially, you know what I mean, for those that was in Miami, you knew how deep he was. You knew what he was driving in. So for individuals to try to minimize Scorpio's representation by what they seen in Pimps Up Hoes Down, you know what I mean? It's very laughable. Another thing is there's a lot of rumors going around, which I ain't going to get into, But it's a lot of rumors that people be trying to minimize Scorpio because of what a bitch told them or what some bitches told them, man. But instead of y'all gossiping like Wendy Williams and shit, you know, ask the man, you know, or come to that man or find out what it is. But you got a lot of niggas in the game that's getting into some evangelism with the criticism on Scorpio's name because of what a bitch told them or what some bitches told them. And they'll take what a bitch said and make that like it's law. You know what I mean? But, you know, Scorpio is Scorpio, man. They can't minimize his legacy in the game. Period. You know what I mean? And a lot of them rumors, nobody ever brought evidence to support a lot of these claims. I really thought that it was really just a bunch of allegations, you know what I mean, to bring down a nigga representation in the game. You know what I mean? A lot of you niggas be sitting over there, you know what I mean, just hating on a nigga because you see a pimp shining. Hold on. There we go, bam. Make sure y'all comments is showing. But yeah, I like when Scorpio said, I love more, nothing more than a happy hoe, happy hook. I love that. You know what I mean? And all the bitches was happy. Bitches was doing hair. They was smiling. And what I really like is when Scorpio said that, you know, I don't want to see y'all working tonight. You know what I mean? We about to go to the players' ball. You know what I mean? And no working tonight. We all coming as a family. And these bitches was so motherfucking filled up with the spirit of hoeing. They was governed by the spirit of hoeing so cold that when Scorpio said that they couldn't do no hoeing, that they couldn't work, them you would have thought that they was little kids and they was told that they was grounded or they wasn't going to get no Christmas gifts. Them bitches really was looking forward to hoeing. You know what I mean? See, that's I like them type of real pimps. Because real pimps, not only basically, you understand me, send a hoe to do some hoeing, but he got her full of joy, the embodiment of joy, to go sit up there and go do some hoeing. Not only is she going to go get the money and bring it back, but she was happy when she brought it. See the difference? Not tricked, not manipulated, not forced, not none of that. Family thing. So I like Scorpio the way he was doing things. I didn't give a fuck about the environment because a lot of the niggas be in mansion homes and some more motherfucking shit and ain't doing an ounce of pimping. So don't let the appearance be the motherfucking interference. Okay, let me see. Yeah, now I have to speak on this, you know, because this was sad. You know what I mean? This was very, very, very sad. And this is why I don't give a fuck about a player's ball or any of that. Matter of fact, before I go in, hit that like button right now. It's 301 of y'all right now. Hit the like button right now. What are you talking about? In the Eddie Long videos, I made it known that I was a backslider. I didn't profess to be a righteous man. God uses whoever he want to use. The gifts and callings of God are without repentance. I was a backslider then, and I'm a backslider now. I haven't said anything different. If you go before my Eddie Long videos, you're going to see me talking about pimping and hoeing. And after them, after I spoke on spirituality, you're going to see me talking about pimping and hoeing after that. And after I even do videos like this, the spirit might move me to bless somebody with some edification or some motivation to sit up there and receive salvation or continue on in God and move up to door number two, which is sanctification. God use whoever he want to use. If he can use a donkey, if he can sit up there and use backsliders and old prophets, you know what I mean, in the old covenant days, he could use the pimping as well. So, you know, blessings to you. Hope you have a prosperous day. But getting back to this game, though, when you look at the film, you see that Snooki got the Pimp of the Year award. Okay? The Pimp of the Year award. That's why that means nothing to me. That means nothing to me. Okay? Snooki got the Pimp of the Year award within the film. And at this time, when Snooki basically got the award, Snooki was working with the feds. So a snitch got the Pimp of the Year award. This is abominable. And this lets you know the day and time that we in when you actually have individuals that try to justify the shit. I don't give a fuck if it was my cousin, brother. It could be Freeze. And if I see this individual as one of my loved ones and I fuck around and see them, you know what I mean? Blessings to you, Ken, loved one. But if I see, you know what I mean, some paperwork or some irrefutable proof showing me that my brother is a snitch, my cousin is a snitch, guess what? I can't fuck with him. This lets you know that niggas ain't who they say they are. Because once a motherfucker, you understand me, get exposed, not no Keisha from False Alert paperwork, the real, genuine, authentic thing, and it's audio, visual, paperwork, reputable, respectable motherfuckers in the street on one accord saying that this individual snitched, and instead of you sitting over there, you know what I mean, coming with the truth, you siding with the lie, you sitting over there in agreeance with this snitch, you chose to love a snitch over the rules and regulations of this game, I can't fuck with you. Hit that subscribe button right now. Hit that bell button. You actually had people that was angry at me for making that video that I made 2 years ago. And all I did was make known that he was not the pimping. Let me tell you something. Whether you're a gangster, whether you're a dope boy, whether you're a pimp, Mac, whatever your title is in the streets, whatever legacy that you created, it's eradicated once you basically have been proven to be a damn snitch. Whatever car you had, whatever amount of money you had, amount of people that you killed from a rival gang, no matter how many niggas you beat up, how many bitches you had, that means nothing once you sit up there and take another man's liberty in society and put him in correctional facility by snitching. And the fact that, see, this is how you know individuals is really not these street niggas that they profess to be. Because just like bitches, they bow down to money. They bow down to materialistic things. The pimping don't do that. Once you show me that you the police, once you show me, you know what I mean, that you have done something contrary, you know what I mean, to this game, as far as snitching is concerned, I can't associate with you. You dead to me. You got certain pimps that are trying to call my phone, talking about, yeah, P, you know what I mean? I missed the videos that you and such and such used to do back in the day, man. You niggas made classics together, man. You know what I mean? You niggas made classics together, man. Y'all need to put that shit behind you, man, and get back to it, man. You and that nigga need to get back to it, man. You niggas made classics, bro. You let Keisha and them men break up your crew, P. You make classics by yourself, man. But, man, you can't deny that, P. You made classics with such and such and such and such and such and such. You made classic with them niggas, P. What they have to understand, the type of man that I am. I'm 34 years old, but in that area, in comparison to them guys, I'm like a grandfather to them because I live by the code and ethics of the game when it comes to that no snitching thing. We have to have some honor among ourselves. And then he responded back in an interview, indirectly but directly to me, telling me that, you know, Snooki said that, you know, he saw it as telling on his enemy. You know what I mean? Matter of fact, this is what I'm going to do. Hold on. Give me 1 second. Just so you individuals know why I did that video. For those of you that had never heard it, give me 1 second. I want you to listen to this interview. I want you to tell me if you hear this or not. But this is why I did that. That's just like you and I. We create an organization. We create a game. And it's a group of us. And one of us sit up there and tell. He's a snitch. And I love the nigga dearly. But because the nigga a weak link, he gotta be deleted. He gotta go. I don't know what type of group y'all come from. But the niggas that I came up around was the type of niggas that'll sit up there and attend your funeral, kiss your mama, quote scriptures. But that's the nigga that took your life because you did something contrary to the life. Okay? You can look this up. I had a partner when I was a young man at Buckingham School. You could probably look up Genesis or Buckingham or just put in Burrell Johnson. Burrell was another close friend of mine. But see, Burrell wanted to make money. He was really a hustler. So Burrell would come around the Moes acting like, you know, he was down with the Moes, shaking up, coming to prayer, all of that. But then he would sit up there, and when he would go to his father's house, different neighborhoods, he was shaking up with the GDs. So he was basically hustling, selling dope, you know what I mean, with the Moes. Then he was selling dope, you know what I mean, with the GDs as a young nigga. You know what I mean? So he could go to certain territories. But what you have to understand is Chicago, a big city, but it's very small, especially when you're in the streets like that. Burrell tried to play both sides. And niggas ended up finding out about it. And once certain people got the whole little demo and found out Burrell's demo, you know what I mean? You know, Burrell basically went to the newspaper. If you look it up on Google, they're going to tell you one way, but that ain't how, you know, what really, you know, I mean, I'm not going to get into all of that as far as names is concerned. But the thing is, Burrell didn't know he was going to get killed. He thought he was just going to go to a regular prayer meet. He thought that he was going to go to a regular meeting, you know, and demonstrate. Lost his life for playing both sides. Love my nigga. Miss him. You know what I mean? Was cool as hell. Had a jumper out of this world. That nigga had a jumper like a white boy. Those that play basketball know what I'm talking about. Nigga had one of them John Paxton, you know what I mean, Steve Kerr type of jumpers. He was ugly with it. But he wanted to play both sides, man. You know what I mean? They ended up killing Burrell, throwing his body on the motherfucking train tracks. So playing both sides and shit, that shit is bad for your health. Real bad for your health. So like I said, that's like us and one of the individuals that's with us, he turned out to be a snitch. We don't want individuals thinking that we accepting snitches among us. So we have to let it be known that he's not a part of us. He was walking with us, but he was never us. So it's the same, you know what I mean, mentality, you know what I mean, as far as with the pimping goes. You have to let that be known, man. Like, hey, man, such and such wasn't, and it was very hurtful. Why? Because, nigga, I'm not going to sit up there and lie. When I seen Pimps Up Hoes Down, I like Snooki's part. I like, one of my favorite parts of the film is when Snooki said, you know, I don't believe in, you know, man, hoes getting all on the bikes, man. How you going to explore a hoe? That was my favorite, one of my favorite parts of the film. I don't believe in hoes getting all on the mic. How you going to explore, ho? And because I was so, you know, young, you know, man, all my niggas, we all saying that. Now I'm saying it to square, bitch, my square ass. I'm saying it to square stuff like, so where you about to go? Oh, I'm about to go kick it with my, you trying to explore. You know what I mean? You trying to explore. How you going to, he said, no, right. No, you can't explore. If you're going to explore, explore another level of this pimping I got for you. You know what I mean? Come on, man. I'm not about to sit up here and put on no Oscar award performance like niggas in the hood didn't like motherfucking Snooki. That's a lie. Why you think it hurt when street niggas, solid niggas, seen that, you know, paperwork, and not only that, him admitting to being, you know, a snitch? Because, yeah, you know, Don was cool. Ken had the little rhymes and shit. But that was Snooki that had the motherfucking rings on fingers and shit. And them bitches had their head down. You know, if you a gangster, you a GD, you a BD, you a Stone, you know what I mean, a Vice Lord, you in the city and shit like that, you see something like that, you like, damn, man, he got them bitches in order. God damn. That trophy big as a motherfucker. But when that nigga sat up there and said that, you know, I don't believe bitches all on the motherfucking mics. Man, how you gonna explore, huh? You know what I mean? If you're gonna explore another level of this pimping I got for you. You know what I mean? Of course, we thought that was, man. You know what I mean? So you had hood niggas, the gangbangers all in the street. Like, bitch, how you gonna explore? You know what I mean? This bitch done got her another man. She fucking on somebody else. This bitch trying to explore. You know, squares. You know what I mean? When young, impressionable minds see something or hear something that they like, they gonna keep repeating and repeating and repeating just like that. You know what I'm saying? That's why it was very hurtful, especially when Snooki was going hard on that bitch. You know what I mean? Come on, man. It's like, man, this nigga, when that nigga's, one of my favorite parts, if not the favorite parts of the film, is when Snooki sat up there and told that bitch, bitch, you's a motherfucking shadow of a pimp. You know what I mean? You a shadow of a pimp. And see, that's one thing, that scene right there, if you see the expression on that bitch face, she was looking at that nigga like, she was mesmerized. She was mesmerized by him. That's what I be telling y'all. Sometimes it ain't about saying 20 and 15 letter words and nursery rhyming and all of that shit. You know what I mean? It ain't about all of that. It's about basically being yourself, saying something and meaning what the fuck you say, getting through to the mind of this woman. You know what I mean? So when that bitch sat up there, you know what I mean? She looked at that and she, bitch, you's a shadow of a pimp. Bow face when you see a pimp, bitch. You understand me? Get in pocket, hoe. She liked that type of shit. And that bitch had the Tanji or whatever the fuck her name was. She knew that she had to like the shit. That's why she had to hurry up and get that bitch away. Because she was getting ready to lose her girlfriend. Because the bitch wasn't no hoe paying another bitch. All right, look. Just so you would know. And I hate to even play this, man. You know what? I might not play this, man. Hey, I'll just say this. Yeah, I can't play this on my shit. This is what you do. Put in Pimp Snooki. Exclusive interview, okay? Matter of fact, fuck it. I play it. Y'all done heard Keisha voice there. I don't know how niggas be on the phone with dude. Dude voice irritating. Niggas sound like the feds. But fuck it. Niggas sound like the feds. Hold on for a minute. But fuck. Bam. Hold on. Let me get it back right. Get the audio together. After this nigga admitted to saying that he was a snitch, these niggas was mad at me for speaking the irrefutable truth. That was crazy. That lets you know that these niggas really wasn't pimps. They was fans. It's my time. Look at this nigga. Got all types of weird ass shit going on.
Using inmate calling time. Subject to monitoring at any time. Thank you for using inmate.
Let me know if you can hear it. Just say I can hear it.
Speaking now.
Yeah, I'm back. Let me do this. I mean, because I never did introduce you, and I'm not gonna introduce you. I mean, I think you can do that yourself. You know, this is the kid KE motherfucking KO Marty. And I'm going to let the dude on the phone just introduce himself because it's You know, a lot of niggas gonna be walking on eggshells. Once you understand and really listen to who the fuck I got on the phone, you know what I'm saying? So the mic is yours, man. Tell these motherfuckers who you are, man.
Hey, man, you know what I mean? This is Derek Gabriel, man. You know, he's better known as Pimp Snoopy, man. You know what I mean? Nothing known as Mr. Marjani, man. You know what I mean? In the raw cut, you know what I mean? Federal lockup, man. Ain't gonna be no motherfucking shake and bake with this shit, man. It's gonna be raw and uncut, man. And all you cats out there talking that bullshit, talking about bank one right, man. How about this, man? I had an IRS on my ass, man, not the feds, man. How about that, man? I mean, IRS only come fuck with niggas who's having money, man. How about that, man? But wait, man, we're gonna get all into that shit. Can't go, you know what I mean? Hey, man, we're gonna make it all right.
Oh,
I ain't got nothing to hold back, right?
Dig that. Man, you know.
Just to pause it for a minute, I don't know how niggas be watching, dude. He got a gorilla mask on, and that's his voice. God damn.
Streets is talking, Snooki. You know the streets is like everybody wants to hear what the fuck Snooki got to say. You know that, right?
Well, you know, it's like this, man. The first thing motherfuckers want, you know what I mean? Oh, man. Is, you know, Snoopy work with them people, man. You know, Snoopy was an informant, man. Snoopy was a rat, you know what I mean? Snoopy was a snitch, man. How about this, man? Can't no motherfucker produce nothing that I done, you know what I mean? And if I done something to him, man, then ask the motherfucking question, what do they do after that? You know what I mean? Yeah, I got out with them people, man. You know what I mean? And I ain't gonna trip about it. And I ain't gonna deny about it.
Hold on, let me go back just so you hear him say it out of his own mouth. I got down with them people.
You know what I mean? Yeah, I got down with them people, man. You know what I mean? And I ain't gonna trip about it. And I ain't gonna deny about it. You know what I mean? It was a treat to get down with them. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Because I'm a boss, man.
And then some individuals actually thought that this was some, like, out of this world. See, you ain't know what he meant by that. You know what I mean? It was a treat to work with him. He was playing them people out of a bag. You know, he was getting to the bag. He was playing the government. When you damn near get sentenced to damn near 20 years, you did not play the people. Time to go back.
I ain't gonna deny about it. You know what I mean? It was a treat to get down with him. You know what I mean?
Not only did he get down with him, but he said it was a treat to get down with him. And this is the individual that they be mad at when the motherfuckers call him what he is. That's sickening. This is terrible. If you a real street nigga, or you sit up there and you playing the game by the rules and regulations, boy, it's a terrible time to be in these streets today. These niggas justify snitching. This nigga said not only did he get down with the feds, but it was a treat to get down with him.
And I ain't gonna trip about it. And I ain't gonna deny about it. You know what I mean? It was a treat to get down with him. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Because I'm a boss, man. You know what I mean? There's a whole lot of boss motherfuckers in the world that fuck with them people, man. It's just to they get to the point where them people don't expose it, man. There's a whole lot of niggas out there that don't debrief and out.
Okay, let me give you a revelation. There are a lot of individuals that you guys consider to be Hall of Fame pimps in the game. But the reality is that a lot of them guys really wasn't no legendary P's. A lot of them guys had a thief or two, or a hoe or two, you know, a bitch or two. But reality is, all of their currency wasn't coming from hoes selling pussy. It was coming from basically getting into a continuity of basically giving information of how other pimps was getting their currency off of bitches selling their pussy. Or basically somebody else in another lane. So whether you told on a pimp, a gangbanger, a stranger, whatever, you cannot get down with the people without basically giving them information. You can't. You cannot get down with the feds without basically giving them the information. Go back and listen to the Alpo interview. Alpo said, no, you know, that's when you basically sit up there and you work with them, you got to go all in. Alpo said it. Go listen to the whole Alpo interview. Alpo basically gave the whole game, you know what I mean, pertaining to snitching. How you got to get down, you got to tell it. You can't testify, sum up, you got to tell it. You got to take your panties all the way off when you a snitch. You cannot take your panties halfway off. They want you to get naked with it. Okay? So this is the person that they defend. This is I never got that. And what they didn't realize is when I said the things that I said, not only was, you know what I mean, I pretty much teaching and preaching basically against snitching and basically abominable, but they not understanding that by him not being a regular individual, but one of the most popular so-called participants that has ever participated, and by him being a face of the game at one time, you know what I mean? And some even see him as a face of the game now. When that whole snitching went down, not only did it make him look like that, but it make the whole game look like that. So we needed an individual, man, to put it out and be like, hey, man, he never was this. He never was this, period. And what's so sad is people within my own community wanted me to fall so bad that they used a case that basically when I first got in the game that the whole game knew about, you know what I mean, especially if you lived in Vegas, in 08, basically you understand me with the minor with the false identification. They don't bring up no false identification. They don't bring up the fact that the police was deceived too. They don't bring up the fact that she was in jail for 3 days before they found out that she wasn't 19, that she was 14 years old. They want to paint a picture like basically the sin was going to parks with 80 pounds of sugar in his pocket, campaigning, looking for little kids, like I was lucky from dead presidents sitting in a Cadillac and little girls with Peter Pan and Barney book bags getting outside and I got a cigarette in my mouth. You know, matter of fact, hold on. Let me give it to you. This is what they try to create sin to be. They try to create this to be me so bad. Little kids is getting out of school. You know what I mean? And I'm just in a, I'm in a damn limo, you know what I mean, with little kids getting out of school and shit. And I got 80 pounds of sugar on me. And I got this plan in the limo or the lack. And I'm just sitting over there. Hold on. No, no. I need something more pimpish than that. I'm just sitting in the limo with a sucker in my mouth like, what's happening? Little girl, little children coming out like, hi, sin. You know what? Yeah, man, you know what I mean? Fuck all of them classes and school and shit. It's really time to get down with the game. You know what I'm talking about? And I'm sucking on suckers and shit like dude and dead presidents. He in the car and shit and be like, how's my little girl? She all right? You know, you got to stop spoiling her. Somebody got to do it. Why they want me to be that individual? That's not me. Niggas in the street know that's not me. Appreciate that, man. Thank you for the five, bro. But that's how thirsty that they was to see me fall. You know what I mean? To see me basically lose the audience, to lose basically who I am, to lose my women and shit. They thought that that was going to cause some shit. You know what I mean? They not going to mention false identification. Now, it was a known fact that basically Snooki had, you know, grown women too, but had minors. Why? Because Snooki was about money. You know what I mean? And the reality is, if motherfuckers really just keep that shit 100, man, they'll let you know that the man really wasn't no pimp. He was exactly what I said in the shit. He was a con artist. Okay. So basically, they gave the Pimp of the Year award, you know what I mean, to a snitch. And my problem with that was, at that time, he had just gotten to a fight. I ain't going to even say this individual's name, with somebody else that's from Milwaukee. And his brother had gotten to a fight with Snooki. And it was told, you know what I mean, to the ism and just street niggas, period, that when basically Snooki got knocked out, the nigga had wires on him. So it was like, how are you fellowshipping and talking to individual that basically got wires on him? See, all of these niggas want to act like, yeah, I always knew he was a snitch. I always knew he was working with the people. They lying. A lot of them niggas that's talking that shit now, them niggas was fans. And even after they found out that Snooki was working with the people, the only reason why they're side with the shit now, because they know that it make them look bad. But, you know, in reality, they don't see nothing wrong with working with the people. So you got individuals that sit up there, you know what I mean, and play it according to the rules and regulations. And then you have other individuals that mix it to fix it, whether it be by selling drugs or basically working with the feds to put basically their enemies away. Because in Snooki's other interview that he did, he said that, you know, I was killing two birds and one stone. You know, I didn't snitch on nobody that was the pimping. I sit up there and was getting rid of, you know, my enemy. This is somebody that I see, you know what I mean, as the enemy. So his way of thinking, you know, he think he playing the art of war. But see, when you actually really a street nigga, you got some basically, you know what I mean, some codes about yourself. You got some principles about yourself. You wouldn't even snitch on your enemy. When you a real pimp governed by real principles, you wouldn't even receive money from a bitch that snitched on your enemy. When you're a real pimp, you know what I mean? Then you have other individuals, you know what I mean? They just get down and dirty, and they think that a pimp is whoever could tell the best lie. And they on some slick manipulation con artist type of shit. But a real street nigga that got principles, that's a man, that's this pimping, he not even gonna break a bitch that basically sat up there and put his enemy in jail or prison. He's not gonna do that because he got standards as a man. So basically, you heard him. I ain't gotta play no more of that shit. If you wanna hear everything in its entirety, just put in Pimp Snooki exclusive interview. And within that, you hear him admitting that he was a snitch. Make sure you hit the like button right now. If you're not subscribed to the channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button right now. You know, but yeah, you got individuals that, oh man, that's my brother. Oh man, that's my cousin. Oh man, that's my hero. Oh man, that was my old folks. And man, I wouldn't give a flying fuck, man. Once that nigga become, you know what I mean, a snitch, and it been put out there that he snitch, it ain't no Chicago, Milwaukee thing. Anybody know me? I got family in Milwaukee. I fuck with Milwaukee. So when I be seeing cats talking about they from the mill and they trying to justify snitching, I be looking at them niggas crazy. They all look crazy. They flew gazy to me. Okay, so hold on. Yeah, exactly. That was a statement that when you look at Pimps Up Hoes Down, you see Snooki make the statement, let me pimp or let me die. And because you see an individual with rings on their finger, they suited and booted, they bras is in pocket, you know what I mean? You think to yourself, man, this nigga really authentic, man. He a true master of the game, man. This nigga is not playing with this game, man. He said, let me pimp or let me die. God damn. Only to find out that this individual that's saying this been working with the feds the whole goddamn time. That's fucked up. Hold on. Right. Exactly. Hold on. See, I don't want to because I'm going on that 3 hours, so I'm going to have to end up wrapping it up. But when individuals, like when you go into the whole spiel of Pimps Up and Hoes Down, there was false information put out as far as, you know, women, you know what I mean? They got to go through a certain abuse. They got to be basically abused mentally, verbally, you know, to basically, you know what I mean, give her money to a man. That's false. Women presiding over women. That's false. Ice-T saying that he's his best hoe. You know what I mean? A lot of you guys, you know, you read Iceberg Slim's book and then you sit up there and you watch, you know what I mean, stuff like, you know, Pimps Up Hoes Down, which a lot of you see as a tutorial on how to pimp. And in reality, this is really a damn tutorial on how to go to jail, how to go to prison, how to disrespect the game. So in reality, you know, no, you know what I mean? This was not a good film. Little few bits and pieces within the film that gave some good information. You know what I mean? Just like when King Bert was like, I think pimping should judge pimping. Not used to be pimping, not once was pimping. And I just like the wisdom of Bishop Don Magic Juan when he says, you know, well, basically, who gonna be the judge, because every pimp gonna say that they number one. So if we don't have a governing body, you know what I mean, to basically give judgment, you know, on it, who gonna come out, you know, with any type of verdict when every pimp think that he number one? So you have to have somebody outside of that, you know what I mean, to basically give a righteous judgment, a correct judgment, logical judgment, judgment according to the rules and regulations of the game, you know what I mean, to basically come out with a verdict. Because even when a pimp holds and dolus, he gonna say that he number one, Cadillac, Phantom, helicopter riding, jet riding, or basically no riding, Greyhound living. You know, a pimp gonna always be number one, you know what I mean, to him. So just to keep that thing, you know, 100, no, you know, had mad respect for what I saw. Yeah, see, I'm gonna keep it real, you know, not just in the Milltown, but even in Chicago, because the man actually, Snooki, had hoes that was about his issue. I don't want you to get it fucked up. I'm not telling you that he didn't have hoes. I'm not telling you that he didn't have bitches that was about his issue. That's not the thing. I'm saying that whatever he did in the game, whatever legacy that he created, has now been eradicated. Now that basically snitching was, it was established that he's a snitch. Once he said, yeah, I got down with the people and it was a treat to get down with them people, he pretty much pulled down his pants and he shitted on anything that we could consider to be credible or legendary in the game. It was over after that. Hold on, there we go. Okay. Yeah, tarnished, diminished, and abolished everything that he had established in the game. That's over and done with. It's gone. You could break a bitch for $1 billion. And if you snitch on your enemy, you know, to maybe to individuals who just respect money over principle, but to the individuals that respect principle over everything, not money over everything, but principle over everything, game over everything, you're going to be a sucker in the eyes of the real. You're going to be a legend. You still going to be that dude to people in poverty, people who basically wasn't blessed with the capabilities to be authentic participants in the game. But to those individuals that's authentic and really in it, you know, you could break a bitch for $1 billion, man. You snitch on one individual. Everything that you've ever done in the game, man, is tarnished, diminished, and abolished, man. It's no longer established. It's gone. It's no more. Finito. So, you know, Pimps Up Hoes Down is not a correct film for any young pimp, any young man to be watching. It's entertaining. Bits and pieces in there. You have real pimps in there. Scorpio, you know what I mean? King Bert, you know, Bishop, of course. Who else was in there that I might be leaving out who did some pimping? I might be leaving somebody out, but, you know, Scorpio, Bert, you know what I mean? Scorpio and Bert and Don, you know what I mean? For sure. I don't remember seeing K-Red up in there. Yeah, I don't remember seeing K-Red. And if K-Red was up in there, and it wouldn't surprise me, because Chicago almost damn near like a second home to him. Yeah, King James a real one. You know what I mean? King James. You know what I mean? Well, I ain't going to get into all of that. But yeah, King James. You know what I mean? King James, Don, Scorpio. You know what I mean? Bishop. You know, these were actual pimps. I'm not going to get into all of that, man. You know, blessings to Ken, blessings to his business and everything that he's endeavoring to be. But no, I'm not going to get into that. Gorgeous Dre was never in Pimps Up Hoes Down. Gorgeous Dre would never participate in a film where bitches is getting rewards for being pimps. You know, no. Mm-mm. It was just too ghetto. It was very, very unpimpish. In a lot of ways, bitches sitting over there pouring milk on themselves and all of that shit. I mean, no disrespect. I mean, if you like, oh, yeah, that's right. King JoJo. JoJo was in there. Yeah. JoJo, definitely a real one. One of the best dressers, you know what I mean, that the game has had. Yeah, JoJo's a real one. That was American, my bad. Yeah, it's cool. I'm going to do American Pimp probably tomorrow. Yeah, I'll do American Pimp tomorrow. Johnny Taylor actually did do some sending and some breaking. I don't know if he actually really pimped on an authentic level, but when you have the popularity that Johnny Taylor had and the music that he was putting out, I mean, how hard is it to break on a bitch? So I don't know if he was officially, pimping in totality. But what I will say is, you know, that's reality. If you got popularity, you know, a bitch gonna give you some pussy and some currency when you Johnny Taylor. You know what I mean? When you got songs like In the Mood. I don't remember Juju even being in Pimps Up Hoes Down. Let me see. Yeah, I don't remember Juju. From my knowledge, Juju wasn't in no Pimps Up Hoes Down. I don't even remember G-Gov. I don't remember Gov being in Pimps Up Hoes Down. I mean, if he was in there, you know what I mean? But I didn't see him. I'm talking about individuals that was in the film. I don't remember them guys, man. You guys got to go back and watch the film. People that I remember that was in the film, of course, Ice-T, Bishop Don Magic Juan, King James, Scorpio, Bert, White Folks, Pimpin' Ken, Snooki. Shit, that's really about it. I'm talking about Pimps Up Hoes Down, man. I'm not talking about any of them other films. We're not talking about cross-country pimping. And listen, man, you guys should be careful of what you ask me. Because you know the type of man I am. If you ask me something, I'm going to give it to you in the raw. You know what I mean? A lot of the niggas that y'all think that's this pimping, they not this pimping. They didn't have some toys. They had some bitches give them some money. But a lot of them guys, man, were dope boys. A lot of them guys was working with the feds, man. How you going to give a person to sell drugs and working with the feds on the side? How you going to sit up there, you understand me, and make them, you know, put them in amongst this pimping, man? How dare y'all, man? That shit ain't right. Hold on. Johnny Taylor was official. I grew up around him. He was good friends with my old man and his partners back in the day. Certified players from Dallas, Texas. Yeah, I heard some things about Johnny Taylor. As a matter of fact, if I'm not mistaken, I think Mel Taylor served Johnny one time. You know, and that's why I said it. You know, I don't know because I got mixed information. And plus, I wasn't there. So I don't want to make somebody official when they really wasn't. And I don't want to say that the person wasn't official when they really was just because one person say this and one person say that. So I just say that I wasn't there. You know, but if I'm not mistaken, I think Mel served him one time. And Johnny Taylor was like, man, why you didn't call me and serve me? He's like, nigga, what was I going to serve you? Nigga, what was I going to do? Hit a note, nigga? What was I going to do? Hit a high note or, you know, sing on key for you, nigga? You know what I mean? I'm just pimping. You know what I mean? So, you know, it's two different crowds. You know what I mean? Mel Taylor's crowd is a little more uppity. You know what I mean? Yeah, a little more uppity, man. So, you know, them guys wasn't driving Cadillacs. Them guys was riding in, you know, Benzes and things like that. You know, Mel Taylor, you know, hopefully Dre will do a video talking about the legacy of Mel Taylor, because a lot of y'all don't know. You know, it be debates about that. A lot of people be debating about who was a better pimp. Was it Dre or Mel and things like that? And the truth really was, you know, I mean, it's whoever you like. That's subjective, you know. But one thing about it is, one thing that I will say is that when Dre got his mansion in Vegas, his second mansion, after he left the mansion in Frisco, and he had pimped up for the mansion in Vegas, and when his father, Mel Taylor, You know, because even when Dre told me that, it was so vivid, I could see it. And Dre was in, you know, his mansion in Vegas, and Mayo, his father, was in the house. He looked at the house, and he saw how beautiful it was, and he looked at Dre, and he said, son, you passed me up. You definitely passed me up, man. You know, you passed me up. You did it, son. Yeah, you passed me up with this one. You really did it this time. You know what I mean? You passed me up. So that's why, you know, people can say whatever, because you got some older pimps that even hate on Dre and say, you know what I mean, that he wasn't this, and when he got out of jail, he be turned into a preacher husband. You got out, but one thing they can't deny is that when Dre was in the game, he pimped. And within that small time in the game, he did things within his 9 years in the game that a lot of people didn't do within 30. Real talk. Now, I'm not going to get into all of this, because if you really know the history of Mel Taylor, I think the deepest that Mel Taylor ever been, I think, was 16 deep. Mel was 16 deep. I think the deepest that Dre ever was, I think Dre had got up to 8 bitches at one time. If it ain't 8, it's 6. But I think Dre had got up to 8 bitches. But Mel was presiding over about 16 brides, man. You know what I'm saying? And then Mel was tall. He was the tall version. That's why his brother, you know what I mean? They all, both of them, you know what I mean, look like Mel, but Mel was, you know, taller. You know what I mean? Shay had a little bit, you know, of his dad, but you see, the older that Dre get, the more he looked like Mel. With that beard. Okay. Tony said, I got to go with Mel. He had knowledge. Hey, Tony, I'm not even mad at you. You know why? Because one time we was on the phone. It was me, Gangsta Brown, and Philmo Slim. And GB sit up there and call Philmo. You can ask him. But according to Philmo Slim, no, Philmo wasn't in Pimps Up Hoes Down. That's Midwest shit. You know what I mean? You got the church movement, and then you got, you know what I mean, the Bay Area thing. So, no, you know what I mean? GB, Philmo, you know what I mean? They wasn't up in, I could just hear Gangsta Brown saying that, no, I wasn't in that. This is Gangsta Brown boy. No, I wasn't in that, you know, because, you know, I was really pimping, you know, and, you know, in the 70s, quote, you know, I was Rolls Royce riding, you know what I mean, even in the 70s, you know what I mean, you know, Sinful, they was really mad at me, man. A lot of these guys were really mad at me, you know. Sinful, they really don't like niggas like you and I, you know what I mean? You know why? Because a lot of them guys, you know what I mean, they get married. They become husbands, they become wives. And I always tell, you know, these niggas, I say, well, you know, if you became a husband, you know, if you got you a wife, you know, and I never got married, you know what I mean? I never did that shit. Nah, I never did that. You know, so quote, if you know me to be a Rolls Royce riding, you know what I mean? $1 million nigga, tailor made ass nigga, hoes down. And I never got married, quote. Then you know that, you know, if you a husband, then what am I? That's all I'm saying. You know what I mean? Simple. That's all I want you to ask the niggas, man. You know, no. What am I? You know, what am I? If I never got married, you know, and if Gangsta Brown, you know, paid his dues, you know what I mean? Philmo, give me the game, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? And brought me into this shit. You know what I mean? My godfather. And once he gave me this game, you know what I mean? You know, everything was on and popping. You know? But sin, you know, that's all I want you to ask them. You know? You know, Who am I? That's all I want to know. I'm not a husband. I never went to prison. All I did was pimp. You know why? Because I followed the rules of the game. I followed the rules of the game. That's why, you know what I mean? There's 100 and, I think you'd be saying 110 or 7 rules of the game. You know what I mean? And I followed them. And I listened to my mentor. I listened to my godfather, Fillmore Slim. And that's why, you know what I mean? I never went to prison. You don't see me married simple. And I'm still young, active, attractive, and still can get these niggas, you know what I mean, a run for their motherfucking money. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Quote, never did heroin. Quote, never drunk any alcohol. Quote, never smoked any weed. You know, quote, they called me the healthy pimp. You know, quote. Oh, shit. Yeah, man, but we was on the line kicking it one time, and Fillmore, I think at that time, I think Fillmore was on tour or just got back from doing a tour. So we just on the phone politicking. And, you know, whenever Fillmore be talking, I'll be listening, because the truth of the matter is, you know, Fillmore has information of things that transpired, you know, back in the day that don't nobody have. You know what I mean? Only a few of them have. So you got to listen to the Ron Newts. You got to listen to the Virgils. You got to listen to the Fillmore Slims, because, you know, in reality, it's only a few P's that can talk about the 60s, the 50s. It's only few. You know what I mean? So you have to cherish their every word. It ain't for you to be going back and forth. That's why a lot of y'all, you know what I mean? You see how I did things. I gave you the blueprint. When an OG or OP say something that's contrary to the truth, it's not for you to correct them at that particular time. You know, you might give a facial expression or something to indicate that you don't agree. But when I did my video with Ron Newton, Virgil, you will see that I didn't cut them off. You know, the GB fuck with Bud. Come on, man. I don't want to start anything, but come on, man. Stop it. Anybody that watched my roasting, I told certain things. I said certain things. And that's why Bub was angry at me, because how did this young nigga know all of this shit? Exactly. Because I'm listening. Even as a young boy, like I told you, I was always soaking up the game. Listening. You know? And even though mentally in a lot of areas, you know, whether people agree to know me, mentally in a lot of areas, I was ahead of a lot of people. But at the same time, you know, whether you have capabilities or not, you still have to use these. And you still have to have more than hoes in the game to like you, to remain in the game. All right? So, you know, everybody wasn't blessed with that skill of listening. But Fillmore on the phone, and he said, man, don't get me wrong. I can't do it. I'm going to need some water to do Fillmore's voice. But Fillmore, you know, he be talking. I'm not even going to try to do Fillmore's voice right now. But Fillmore, I'm not going to lie. He said, Dre, gorgeous Dre. He said, Dre was pimping. He said, he did some good pimping. You know? He did some good pimping. But he always made nothing. But he said, that motherfucker Mel Taylor, man, was a motherfucker. That motherfucker, Mel Taylor, was a motherfucker. That motherfucker, Mel Taylor, was a mother. He said, Dre, he was pimping. You know what I mean? Excellent house. You know, dress well. You know what I mean? Good pimp. Had nice. He said, he really pimped. He said, but his father, though, Mel Taylor, bad motherfucker, man. That was a bad motherfucker. So, you know, to feel Mo, you know, Fillmore, of course, slide with Mel. But then again, like I told you, Mel gave props to his own son, you know, and then let his own son know that he had surpassed him in the game. Hey, Coco. Hey, make sure you hit the like button. Make sure you hit the, before I get out of here, we over 3 hours now. Make sure you hit the like button. Hopefully, man, because I'm about to go take care of some shit. I got to answer all these text messages and all this shit. But hit the like button, hit the share button, make sure you hit the subscribe. You know what I mean? But let me say this to you. So number one, you know, all of the women, I want you to know before I leave, there's no such thing as a female pimp. You know what I mean? There's no such thing as a female pimp. No, I don't talk to Bishop. Not that I wouldn't, but no, I don't talk to him. I'm not even affiliated with anybody from the church. I've spoken to some. I know some. Me and Bert didn't have, you know, some few conversations. I like Bert. You know, he's a blessed man. Plus, he's in the spirituality now. But no, I don't really. You don't see sin at players' balls and, you know, hit the bishop voice. Oh man, Tony, y'all want me to? Y'all like that bishop voice, you know what I mean? But y'all know that's his voice. But let me just get these reasons out, though. The reason why this was a terrible film, the reason why this was a bad documentary, is because it was basically residing in an abiding in young, impressionable minds, and Pimps Up, Hoes Down was a tutorial to young people on how to pimp, when in reality, it was a tutorial on how to do things backwards. You know, this shit was some mediocre, you know, Calabunga, Nickelodeon type of game that was given. It wasn't on the level. You know what I mean? So, number one, there are no female pimps. Two, a pimp is not his best hoe. As a matter of fact, a pimp is not a hoe at all. Number three, you know, as far as players' balls, if you want to have them, you can have them. That don't mean that you is or you ain't this pimping if you attend. But don't think that you King Tut around here and you paying for, you know, because a lot of them guys, them players' balls, man, they be paying for awards, you know, and that ain't pimp, man. And then another thing, you know, if you ever snitched before in your life, you know, how could you ever be considered to be this pimping and you the snitch? And the fact that a snitch was given the Pimp of the Pimp of the Year award, very distasteful, disrespectful. It was just very abominable, man. Just nasty. You know, and so we learned that no female pimps. No damn, you know what I mean? As far as, oh, of course, Ice-T with the no pimp, not a hoe. I taught you guys, I've been told you this, but, you know, pimps don't get turned out. Pimps get introduced to the game. You know what I mean? Introduced to the game, not turned out to the game. And, you know, when Bishop was basically talking about his past when he was abusive and, you know what I mean, putting hoes in their place like he was supposed to, because a lot of y'all considered it to be abusive, you know, pimps in the game, just considered it to be, you know, doing what was vital to his title, especially in them old times. But, you know, because it wasn't conveyed right, or it was conveyed right, but like I said in the beginning, you know what I mean, when you do a film, the filmmakers can have 2 and 3, 4 hours of footage of you talking, and reality is that they're not going to put 3-4 hours of you talking in a fucking film. They're going to edit, you know, and take the parts out that would pretty much, hey Coco, that would pretty much be, you know, exciting to squares to make the movie sell. I don't blame them. So, you know, Don might have conveyed it, so I'm not saying that he didn't convey it right. Please don't go back causing bullshit when reality is things might have been edited. But a lot of those young people saw Don talking about hanger whoopings, stick whoopings, and a lot of these guys didn't have game enough to knock a grown woman. So you had guys that was 25 and in their 30s, you know what I mean, having 13-year-olds, 14-year-olds, 15-year-olds, 16-year-olds, 17-year-olds knowingly, not ignorantly, not no false identification shit. He knowingly knew, you know what I mean, that this girl was a girl. And, you know, there was a time, I'm just telling it like it is, in the city of Chicago, where you would see teenagers walking up and down the blade, and the police wouldn't say shit. The police would not say shit to these teenagers that they knew that was involved with pimps, and they didn't say shit. But when you have individuals that are impressionable, and they're watching, you know what I mean, a film like this, and you got Don saying, you know what I mean, you had to know that she was a thoroughbred. You had to, that mean hanger whooping, stick whooping, you know what I mean? Sometime, you know what I mean? If you told a broad that you was going to kill her, you had to make sure that, you know what I mean, that you meant that. Because when you say that you're going to kill a broad or you're going to sit up there and do something, you had to let her know, you know what I mean, that you was going to do it, you know? Otherwise, she wasn't going to believe that you was the pimp. She got to be a thoroughbred. She got to be ready for the Kentucky Derby. You know what I mean? That's how you know that she was fresh and ready for the track, Jack. You know, so you basically, you understand me when you get, you stupid, Jay. You know, but when you got a lot of young, impressionable minds watching that, they got a 14 and 15 year old broad willing to prostitute for them. And when this 14 or 15, 16, 17, sometimes 12 year old do something contrary to what these youngsters think that's right, that's in their early 20s or might be 19 or might be early 30s. And they gonna pretty much go off of what Don said in the film and pretty much beat the broad and go upside her head. Hang a whooping, stick whooping. You know why? Because he thought that these stories, you know what I mean, that Don is telling, this is a tutorial on how to pimp. Not knowing that when Don did these things in the 70s and 80s and things like that, he did these things when the laws were different. So you got to be a young, dumb motherfucker to watch these films and actually think that you about to repeat the same thing that they did physically about a century ago and try to apply it in 2018 and think that you're not going to lose your liberty in society. You got to be a plumb fool. You young people, when you listen to these older pimps, you have to understand that they're speaking from an autobiographical perspective. They're giving you their biography. They're telling you the game from their perspective, or what happened within their experiences. And what you have to understand is, nigga, that was pretty much 40 years ago. That was 40, damn near, some of their experiences, damn near 50 years ago. So the things that you could get away with back then, that's not the way you get back with it then. So Pimps Up Hoes Down, you know, for a young gangbanger or a guy that has problems with women, that grew up hating his mom, and you know, I always tell people that, you know, who a person was before the game is going to play a big part in who he's going to be in it. And the truth of the matter is, you got a lot of guys that had a lot of hatred, anger towards their mother, had anger towards their sisters. So they really didn't get along with women. It has nothing to do with being a pimp. Every husband is not an abusive husband. Every boyfriend is not an abusive boyfriend. Every pimp is not an abusive pimp. So this film, watching Snooki with the women with the head down and seeing women walk up and down the street looking sad and depressed, looking like they're in need of a blessing, and then to hear Don testify about how he used to have Ali bouts with hoes and shit, this would give a young, impressionable mind, you know, that I need to, and listening to Ken talking about she got to go through a certain abuse, you know what I mean, as a child to be a participant in the game, it'll give a young impressionable mind that I need to find a woman who got low self-esteem, or I need to find somebody who been through a certain amount of abuse, you know, that basically that I can mash on, smack, call her a bitch, and she won't have a problem with it. You know what I mean? So, and that lets you know what Ken said, you know, we consider that to be square because, you know, calling a bitch has never been disrespectful. you know, but to a square. And I gave you the reason for that. You know what I mean? But when you go through this film, you can understand why young people would beat on teenagers. A young guy that want to be a pimp that don't know nothing about this pimping, wasn't laced right, only watching a film and going off that film, you can understand why he's beating on this 16-year-old, 17-year-old, because, hold on, this 16-year-old and 17-year-old, you know what I mean, like that. The reason why is pretty much, you know, he don't have a mentor. So he don't have nothing but films and rap songs to go off of. And by that being the only thing that he going off on, he's predestined for somebody's jail. So even though, you know, I do still got more to say, because I always got more to say because of who I am. And there's always some more of it due to the fact that I've spoken over 180 minutes pertaining to the topic. I'm going to wrap it up. You know what I mean? And for those of you that would like to replay and, you know what I mean, go through it. You know, I mean, I gave information about, you know, what is, what ain't, and things like that. And hopefully I'll be back later tonight if I can. If I can't, then you already know I didn't lie to you. It was just that I got caught up. I had to do some things. But before you guys go, do me this one favor. I want one of my mods to click on channels and go get the link for my Blade Music Videos channel and put it in the comment section. Jay or Tony or one of y'all, you know what I mean? Go get one of my, go get the hashtag. Yeah, I'm going to do American Pimp either tomorrow or the day after, but I'm pretty sure I have time to do it tomorrow. I'll make it time for it. But, you know, I want you guys to basically put the link up in the comment section for the Blade Music Videos channel. And I want everybody to subscribe right now to the link. Jay, put it up in there a whole bunch of times. Put that link up in there a whole bunch of times so they can see it. You know what I mean? To make sure they get it. But everybody click on that link. And I want you to go over there and subscribe and hit the bell button and subscribe to the channel, because another reason is because Freeze just did the ZZ for Kodak Black. You know, Kodak Black got a song with Offset and Travis Scott called ZZ. Freeze got on the beat, man, and they should just get a beat to Freeze. So I want you to go there. I want you to get in the comment section. I want you to hit the like button. I want you to share the video. Let's hurry up and get that channel over 1,000 subscribers. You know what I mean? So it could be bigger and better. But I'm only putting out music that basically pretty much promotes the life. You stupid, Helena. You done. Okay, Sunshine, thank you for that, baby. I'm going to put a music video probably after this, too. Matter of fact, and if you didn't see the link, everybody always do that. Hit the subscribe button. I mean, not the subscribe button, the channel. Always come to my channel. And when you see channels, click on channels and just subscribe to all my channels, to the Sinful Views channel, because I'm about to start going hard over there. And if I got time tonight, I'm going to be on the Game for Ladies channel with some of the ladies that, you know, I'm going to do videos with. And let me also say this, for the ladies that desire to do a video with me, go to SIN2_FUL, jump into the DM, and let me know what you would like to question me about, debate with me about, or speak about your life or whatever. You know, come through the Game for Ladies channel. Also, you know, I want you to follow me on Instagram, simply because any question that you may have, that's why I'm doing. Still going to do questions over here, but it's easier for me to answer questions at Instagram, simply because you can see both of our faces. So that's why I like it better at Instagram, because I can look at the individual that I'm talking to. But it is what it is. Make sure you go to Freeze channel, F-R-E-E-Z-E-I-Z-I-T. Subscribe to his channel. Make sure you go to Andre Taylor, Gorgeous Dre. Subscribe and hit the bell on his channel. David, I think he's gone. But pretty soon, all my my family that's been fucking with me for a while, it's time to do videos, family. I want you to create your own channel and get you started so you can be doing your own thing. I love you guys. I hope you live as long as you want. Never Want As Long As You Live. Make sure you hit the like button. Make sure you hit the share button. Love y'all. Talk to you later. One.